the Busch Grand National standings, one Chevrolet and one Ford. The Chevrolet is that of Johnny Benson, but Benson has not yet seen success on the longest, fastest tracks of NASCAR. The Ford is that of Chad Little, who started 42nd at Daytona and wound up in victory lane. What's the difference on the biggest, fastest tracks between these two? Well, could it possibly be something in the air? CNN Motorsports presents live coverage of the Humminbird Fishfinder 500K from the world's fastest speedway in Talladega, Alabama. It is a muggy, sweltering, drip, dry day for racing here at Talladega. The temperature is in the 90s and the humidity is right up there to match. Breaking a sweat, but waiting for a great race. Hi, everybody. I'm Mike Joy. What a great day we've got here to run at Talladega. The fastest Busch drivers set to go in their fastest, longest race of the season. And to a man, they all say, I can pass anybody I can catch. But they can all pass me, too. It's going to be a 190-mile-an-hour chess game, and who better to speak to that than my two broadcast partners who've each won four Winston Cup races at Talladega, Buddy Baker and Darrell Waltrip. Buddy, there is something in the air here. The drivers that have the experience at working the draft seem to do very, very well, and most of the Busch regulars don't have that much experience here.
Well, Mike, it's pretty simple. What happens is when you're good enough to win on major speedways on a regular basis, like Chad Little did in Daytona, hey, they go over to the Winston Cup side. That's the basic thing. This is a big chess game. They're chess masters. That's why the Winston Cup guys win more races at Talladega and Daytona than the Busch drivers do.
You miss it here, don't you?
Oh, yeah, big time.
Darrell Waltrip's won four Cup and an IROC race here at Talladega. The Winston Cup drivers used to come in here and gang up on the Busch regulars, but there's not so many of them out there today.
No, there's not as many Winston Cup drivers as normal, but a lot of drivers in the field see a window of opportunity here. If you look back at the history of this racetrack, there are a lot of one-time winners here. And so I think that's something that these guys all pay attention to, and they say, hey, this is my opportunity to win a big race in front of a lot of Winston Cup teams, and maybe I can make that big move. But it'll be an exciting race, and it's like Buddy said, they're going to be dicing out there all day long.
Okay, let's go down to the starting grid and Glenn Jarrett.
Well, thanks, Mike. This man seems to have a standing invitation for the pole here in the Busch Grand National Race. Jeff Purvis, for the second year in a row, has set fastest time. This thing has been a rocket ship all week. These guys having a hard time keeping up with you, Jeff.
Yeah, they'll probably catch up here when they get in the draft and team up on me. But now this Kodak Fun Saver car has really been good, and it unloaded fast. You know, we came down and tested last week, and we knew we had a pretty good race car. We just didn't know how good they were going to come back.
What about the heat and humidity? How are you going to fight that?
Just the best I can. It's hot. You know, we drink plenty of fluids, and, you know, I'm worried about the people in the pits also and in the stands. It's pretty hot down here today, but if you're running good, you can fight it off pretty good.
Okay, best of luck to you. Jeff has a lot of fans in this area. This is his favorite one right now, keeping him cool. Let's go to the Busch Grand National Garage area and Larry McReynolds.
Thanks, Glenn. I'm standing here by the NASCAR trailer. You know, in Busch Grand National racing here at Talladega, the competition has become so tough that maybe teams will press the envelope just a little bit to get any advantage that they can. Now, one gain that can really be made is to modify the deck lid to get the spoiler down out of the air. The NASCAR rulebook states that all deck lids on all makes must remain completely stopped. In an extensive inspection here on Thursday, NASCAR found these deck lids that had been modified. They made these teams take these deck lids off, confiscated them, made them put stock deck lids on. Now they can go racing. So at least I think we can say that all the deck lids in the race today, they at least will be stopped. Let's go back up to Mike.
More information, you can call Larry McReynolds at 1-800-DECK-LID. No, don't do that. Please don't do that. But please stay right here, and we'll be back with the starting lineup after these messages.
Oh. This is Dale Jarrett's NASCAR. You can't get his engine, you can't get his tires, but you can get his motor oil. Texaco Haviland Formula 3. It's formulated to control volatility and fight oil vaporization. It provides complete protection, and it's the exact same Haviland you can buy right off the shelf, which, by the way, is a heck of a lot easier.
Add more life to your car. Take it to the star.
In Floyd's Knobs, Indiana, people drive from miles around just to see Don Ballard. Because when it comes to car repair, well, there's not much he can't fix. You see, Don's the type of guy who believes that doing a job right and saving money go hand in hand. So he begins each job with a trip to AutoZone. Sure, it's a 20-mile drive. There are other parts stores along the way. But for Don, when it comes to getting the right part for the right price, there's just no place better than AutoZone.
Spitfire earned a United States patent. Spitfire doesn't look like any other spark plug. And the patented Spitfire doesn't work like any other spark plug.
5 extra horsepower by merely installing these plugs. Quicker in the quarter mile. A 4.8% gain in mileage.
There's nothing like a Spitfire. You'll get more power and more mileage, or your money back. Get the guaranteed Spitfire advantage at leading automotive stores from coast to coast.
Excuse me? That's better. Excuse me? That's better. Excuse me? Excuse me. There's nothing better than a steak from Winn-Dixie.
Today's exclusive coverage of the Humminbird Fish Finder 500K on TNN is brought to you by Haviland Formula 3 Motor Oil. Add more life to your car. Take it to the star. By the more than 1,000 AutoZone stores across America. AutoZone, the best parts in auto parts. And by Spitfire, the patented performance spark plug. It only costs more till you use it.
Welcome to Talladega, where a little bit of a breeze has picked up, and the folks out in those grandstands and infield are really going to enjoy that. Today is AutoZone Race Analysis, brought to you by the more than 1,000 AutoZone stores across America. AutoZone, best parts in auto parts. 117 laps is the distance. It's the longest race on the Busch Grand National Circuit. Ken Schrader, last year's winner, holds the race record. Look at that average speed, 167 miles per hour. 65 down pit road today. Let's have a look at the starting lineup. Jeff Purvis broke his own track record to take his second straight pole. Mike McLaughlin, who won at Dover, those are both Ron Hutter engines in those Chevrolets. Row 2, Joe Nemechek, second top 5 start. And Jeff Green, who has climbed 10 spots in the points in the last 2 months. Phil Parsons makes his best start of the season. He'll roll off 5th, and Mike Wallace, second at Dover. Chad Little, 4-time winner, second in the points. And Dale Fishline, who nearly won this race last year, he's Dave Marcus's Sunday race day crew chief. Row number 5, Elton Sawyer, 9th top 10 start for Elton this year. And David Green, last year's Busch champion. Row number 6, Hermie Sadler. 2 top 10s and 2 Talladega starts. And Hut Strickland makes his first Busch start of the season. Patty Moise, her first Busch Series start at Talladega, we're told. And Kevin LePage has a new Monte Carlo this week. Bobby Dotter stands 10th in points, and Jason Keller, the third-place point man. Johnny Benson Jr., 2-time winner this year and the point leader. Kenny Wallace, winner at Richmond in March. Steve Grissom, who won at Bristol, and Bobby Hamilton makes his first Busch start since April. Jimmy Spencer and Larry Pearson, who won at Darlington and Myrtle Beach. Jeff Fuller, second in the rookie points with 4 straight. Top rookie of the race finishes, and Mark Martin, who looks for his first Busch win since dominating at Rockingham last year. Ken Schrader, defending champion of this race, and Tracy Leslie, who was 4th here 2 years ago. Michael Waltrip ran a close second in this race 3 years ago, and Tim Fedewa, who won at Nazareth in May. David Bonnet makes his first Busch start at Talladega, and Ward Burton is in the Caterpillar car for the 4th time this year. Jim Bowne had a 3rd at Atlanta, and Terry Labonte, the winner at Watkins Glen last month. Tommy Houston finished 9th here in 92, and Curtis Markham with 4 straight top rookie finishes. He's the rookie leader now. Robbie Reiser makes his Talladega debut, and Randy Porter, his 9th start of the year. Johnny Rumley has a pair of top tens, and Stevie Reeves, who was sixth at Richmond. Rodney Combs, ninth in the point standings, and Rick Wilson makes his first Busch start since Charlotte. Finally, Doug Hebron, who was second at Nazareth, and Randy LaJoy taking over the Dennis Shoemaker ride. Dirk Stevens exiting that car. LaJoy, the runner-up here 2 years ago, completes the starting lineup. In one lap, they'll go racing. Here, they did not qualify for this race. Troy Beebe, Rich Bickle in the Kleenex car, Andy Belmont, Jeremy Mayfield. And then Bobby Jones' car and Greg Sachs did not make the field. We'll have several in-car cameras for you today. From Mark Martin's Winn-Dixie Ford, you'll have this view over Mark's shoulder. And also off the roof of Mark's Ford, looking ahead at Larry Pearson there. Here's Mark ready to go to work. And Jason Keller, the Budget Gourmet Chevrolet, will give you these views as he looks forward to Kevin LePage and Patty Moise. One row ahead. More like what Jason sees is this view here from the top of the roof. Looking forward. And Jason set to go. Elton Sawyer in the Aiken Sutton Ford Credit Red Carpet Lease Ford. We'll have this view, and also from the window post, we'll look over at Elton Sawyer. And bumper cam returns on TNN. That's located just sitting on top of the rear bumper, below the taillight pin. And Randy LaJoy from the scratch starting position in the Duraloo machine, starting in 42nd place in that Chevrolet out of Norwalk, Connecticut. Dashboard, or kind of looks like a tachometer camera there, facing back at Randy. And David Bonnet in the Humminbird Fish Finder Chevrolet of noted fisherman Hank Parker. Here's a look forward from the roof of David Bonnet's car. And there's the second generation speedster ready to roll here at Talladega. Out for a little bit of air on this final pace lap.
Well, I say one thing, we got plenty of cameras. We got them covered front to rear, inside and out.
That's right. And we're set to go. Liz Allison will wave the grand flag for this event. Jimmy Houston, another great fisherman, was out here. He wasn't casting lures. He was given the command to fire engines. No. Spokesman for Humminbird.
Well, I tell you, Mike, when they come down to take this green flag, I want everybody to hold on to their seat belts, to hold on to their seats, because this is the wildest start in racing right here at Daytona and Talladega. Everybody rushing off into that first turn. It's real exciting. The first three or four laps will be like nothing you've seen anywhere else.
Can you hold your breath for 2 hours?
Not just kind of heat.
Some folks may have to. Watching the practice and the drafting and getting ready for this show, unbelievable. Liz Allison waves the green flag. Somebody a little slow coming up. David Green there from the fifth row held up that outside lane from four cars on back. That's the big break you see on the outside. They're four wide in turn one. Good grief. That didn't take long. That's Kenny Wallace way up top in the Red Dog car. And there's Johnny Benson, the red car there, 74. Rodney Combs. Here come the leaders.
Mike, it takes them about one lap to really get going here. Right now, they're coming up in RPM. Right now, getting the car up to full song. As they come off turn four here, you can see that already Jeff Purvis has got him a nice lead. He's been on the pole by quite a bit, almost 6 tenths of a second. So he's much quicker than the second place car. But in this racetrack, you can draft right up on a car. You can be 5 miles an hour slower, Kevin.
Leading the field. Those two Ron Hutter prepared 9-1 Chevrolet V8s, Jeff Purvis and Mike McLaughlin in Chevrolets. Kenny Wallace, black flag, jumping the start. He'll get a stop and go penalty.
Boy, that's just like telling him he's out of the show almost. So when you stop here and lose that lead draft, you can really lose more than just track position.
Look at Schrader on the bottom in 52, the AC Delco car, as you watch from Jason Keller.
Yeah, I think he and Michael are really trying to get hooked up and move up to the front. They didn't get a good qualifying run, and those two cars should be capable of running up front when they get together and work their way to up there.
Single file in front of the field. Purvis leads them around. Two wide, back about 12th place.
Mike, what you try to do here is never get caught in the middle. Be the third car, one in the middle. You don't want that because the outside and inside lane will pass you by.
Three wide in the start-finish line. Ward Burton, Bobby Dodd, Elton Sawyer.
Jeff Green just went into second place in the three car there. Boy, that car is really handling well. I noticed when he turned in there, he made the pass little or no effort at all. Now, just right on by.
What happens to McLaughlin down on the inside by himself?
Well, let's see. How many cars are in this race? 42. I guess he's going to be about 42nd here in about a lap.
Look at Jeff Green go right by Purvis going into turn three.
Jeff Green on the outside.
Mike Wallace right there in the green and black car, the number 90 you see on the outside.
And that blue car is Dale Fishline, number 70. Remember last year he led this race, had an ill-timed pit stop, dropped it back to 14th. But he is a contender. Dave Marcus' crew chief is sliced down in front of Purvis there.
See, Mike Wallace used that draft. He went across the back of the car, picked up all the draft off Jeff Green's car and went right to the lead.
High Groove is going to move around Fishline this time. There's Purvis, in behind that blue number 70. Here comes Green in number 3, way up the outside.
See, what you do here, Mike, is a lot of defensive driving. You can make the wrong
move. This is defense?
Yeah, well, it turns out to be here in a minute.
This is defense?
Got to get the ball first. And the 3 car just got the ball.
Yeah, that's Joe Nemechek in the 87 running second there. He made quite a move on the back straightaway there. And look who's already up there. Chad Little making a bid on the outside in yellow and red car there, the number 23.
Little start at 7th. Look at them fan out 3 abreast down this 1,500-foot short chute into the trioval. Mike Wallace comes down across the nose of the 20 car.
See, Wallace was leading the lap before. Look at him. He's going straight to the back. He could end up, in 21st position just by getting in the wrong spot.
3 wide, 4 rows deep.
This guy on the outside, all the way up against the wall, he better hope that everybody knows he's out there, because if you pull across and hook bumpers there, that's a bad thing to happen.
Forget the score sheet, folks. How'd you like to score this?
Well, how would you like to be in the middle of it?
No.
It's really nerve-wracking. This is the hardest kind of racing there is, not physically, but mentally.
On the bottom, Fishline and Purvis continue to work together, while on the high groove, Jeff Green, Joe Nemechek. Up top, Michael Waltrip has come from 27th into the top dozen.
He'll be a factor. I know he always runs well here, and he gets him a little help. He'll get up to the front.
Now they're going to split Fishline and put him in the middle lane where Buddy said you didn't want to end up.
He didn't have much choice there. They just dove under him going in the corner there. You see, he had to fall back in line. Now he's trying to get in the draft and make it. He's right back up in the good spot.
Yeah, what we'll have here before too long is 2 distinctive lines. You'll have a low line and a high line. They'll just sit there and they'll jockey back and forth.
How about 4 wide? How about 4 wide?
How about that? Good grief.
I'd like to say that won't work, but obviously it will.
It will for a minute. Coming around to complete 6 laps here at Talladega. And it's any one of, 30 or so cars that could lead this thing. Live coverage on TNN continues right after this. Hold your breath.
You're beautiful. You're everything I ever want.
If you love your car, what you put on it should be more than just a wax. New Zymol Natural Liquid Auto Polish protects your finish with beeswax and shines with rare Brazilian carnauba. Safe, naturally derived ingredients. So pure, powerful. Perfect.
Oh, so beautiful.
New Zymol Natural Liquid Auto Polish.
I remember when the only choice was aspirin. Next came Tylenol, but couldn't always handle all my tough headache pain. And now there's Aleve. But if pain comes back once you've taken it, you could be in pain hours before you can take more. No thanks.
For me, the best choice is Advil. I can take Advil the way I want to.
Advil contains the number one doctor-prescribed pain reliever in its class in non-prescription strength.
Nothing is proven to work better or last longer than Advil. Nothing.
Advanced medicine for pain.
The newest way you can cure athlete's foot is the way doctors cure it. With the same ingredient they've prescribed millions of times. It's new Prescription Strength Desinex. Nothing cures athlete's foot better. New Prescription Strength Desinex. The doctor's cure.
One of these hammers is jacketed in high-impact polycarbonate. The other one is broken. The fiberglass jacketed hammer from Stanley.
Every day, we all find a way.
A promise made, a promise kept, giving it our best.
America's most complete source of auto parts, a national warranty program, and customer service only NAPA can give. No wonder more people trust NAPA to keep their vehicles running.
We can.
Today's exclusive coverage of the Humminbird Fish Finder 500K on TNN is brought to you by NAPA. We keep America running.
Things have settled down, but only marginally up front. Jeff Purvis at the front, five-car draft. They're trying to break away. Everybody else is trying to find a place in line, and big trouble in the air. Goes Mark Martin on his roof. It is Ward Burton, excuse me. Jim Bowne is in the wall. Phil Parsons has spun. Tommy Houston spins. And it's a tremendous slide down the front straightaway.
Wrecking, Mike. They're still wrecking down there in turn one.
Rodney Combs and three other cars have crashed at turn one to end this one.
Yeah, that was Ward Burton that got upside down.
The one good thing, the car did stay on the roof and it went down through there. It didn't start flopping around a whole bunch.
Yeah, the good thing is it's a new pavement they've done right here. This really helped.
Darrell, he's taking the net down and coming out right now. All right.
What a slide for Ward Burton.
Well, you see where the car is, Mike? That used to be grass. If that was still grass, that car would have went flipping. But because it's asphalt, they just slid and came to a halt.
They're up with working with Stevie Reeves up there at the outside wall, dropping the window net to get Stevie out. You see Jason Keller, the front end of his car. He's run into something. A grinding crash here on the 11th lap. Ward Burton is okay.
It looks like Ward just got loose in the trial with here. And
that, I believe, is Phil Parsons.
Yeah,
walking back, he is okay.
Well, that's one of the first times I've ever seen the roof flap not keep the cars down, but it was on the flat part of the racetrack where it lifted.
Let's show you what happened here.
You look back in there, I see what happened. He got a tap. Ward got hit by Johnny Benson, I think it is. And that's
the flat part of the racetrack. When he made the come back up on the racetrack, it flipped right up. The nice part of this, the car stayed on the roof. It did not start tumbling.
Right.
And everybody scatters.
Rodney Combs got in it there. You see the 43.
Yeah, it's just hard to take the evasive out. You never know which way to go. You don't know to go low. You don't know to go high. You can't hit the brakes. If you do, you crash.
And the other thing, you see all that smoke. Well, that looks bad there, but down on the racetrack, it's blinding. You cannot see through that smoke.
Here's another look. You'll see the initial contact here.
The one with Cat on it just getting tapped right there.
Now, the important point, if we can stop right there, when he goes to the flat, see, the roof flaps are up, and they're trying to do their job. But he's gone to that sharp angle between the racetrack and the apron, and that's what allows air to get under the car.
Right, it's that transition of the racetrack.
Oof. Well, I know that looks terrible, but that was a good break that the car didn't start flipping over and over.
All right, we'll take the damage report and fill you in on who else has been involved in this incident and what the status of their cars are. When we come back, the best news we have is that as far as we can determine, everybody involved is okay. We'll update you as soon as we come back.
Isn't it time you stop letting life slip through your fingers? Go for it and grab on. Grab on and live wide. You'll never let go.
More power, more electrodes, faster start.
Suddenly, everybody has a new spark plug idea promising instant higher performance. But one new plug's idea is higher performance that lasts. Introducing Autolite Double Platinum. Platinum on both sides of the gap for faster starts and more power every time. Platinum to platinum firing for guaranteed peak performance, long after other ideas have peaked out. Autolite Platinum and now Autolite Double Platinum. More precious metal for your precious metal.
Today's exclusive coverage of the Humminbird Fish Finder 500K on TNN is brought to you by Allied Signals Auto Light Spark Plugs. Guaranteed for 2 years. no matter how far you go.
Some of the cars that still sit down in turn number one include those of Bobby Hamilton, Curtis Markham. Now, they were caught up in what I would call the third incident, and Randy Porter. Bill Parsons' car was hard into the wall. He was squeezed into the wall by the machine on its roof, sliding the Ward Burton car. Jim Bounds' machine is also still there. Everyone else has made it back to the garage area. Here's Larry McReynolds.
David, I know we kind of keep interviewing you in these situations. That's probably one of the worst wraps we've seen here at Talladega since the roof flaps come along. What did you see from your vantage point?
Well, first of all, Larry, you know, it's the typical Busch race. There's 30-some cars going for the lead, it seemed like. And I had the outside there, and I thought it was going to be the lane, but, there, you know, nobody would work with nobody. And I guess I saw Ward's car go up there, and I slowed up, and Hutch Strickland was behind me, you know, and he got into me. But there's nothing you can do going that fast. But the roof flaps worked a little while, it looked like, but over he went.
You going to get that Slim Jim Chevrolet back out there today?
Well, I tell you, this is awful disappointing. We had a best effort here on the speedway, and it really felt good, racy with it, but without a rear spoiler here, Larry, you know, that's like walking on a thin blade of ice right there. So I don't know. We'll see what happens.
I tell you guys, the cars just keep stacking up here in the garage area, so a lot of work going on down here.
Yeah, Larry, and I think it's important for us to make the point another time. The roof flaps did their job. What allowed the air to get underneath that car was the transition from the banking to the flat. When Ward Burton went across that area, it allowed, there was a big area underneath the car, air got underneath there, and that's why that car turned over. Let's show you from in-car what happened. This is Randy LaJoy.
Those cars up on the racetrack there, that was long after the accident actually occurred, and that was reaction to what happened to actually Randy LaJoy, who was way back in the wreck.
They were trying to move around his car that was
right.
Stopped there.
And right.
Mike, that was probably the best footage I've ever seen on a wreck. That was exactly like you were in one of those
That's
cars
right.
That was being hit.
It was, buddy.
Makes me like my seat up here a whole lot.
And mine.
We'll be right
and
back.
And mine.
Dear Midas, my wife's brake light had been flashing on, so we took the car to a repair shop. They failed to properly inspect the brakes and solve the problem. Then we took the car to Midas. Russ did a proper inspection and told me,
"Well, your brake pads are worn, causing your master cylinder to use more brake fluid, in turn causing your light to go on."
Then I got new pads and a guarantee. I should complain to that repair shop, but I wanted to congratulate you instead. Thank you. Dave Buchanan.
You're beautiful.
If you love your car, what you put on it should be more than just a wax. New Zymol Natural Liquid Auto Polish protects your finish with beeswax and shines with rare Brazilian carnauba. Safe, naturally derived ingredients, so pure, powerful, perfect.
Oh, so beautiful.
New Zymol Natural Liquid Auto Polish.
Once you watch, you're hooked. Live from Topeka, Kansas, it's the NASCAR Super Truck Series Heartland Tailgate 175. Next Saturday, 6 p.m., 5 Central on TNN Motorsports.
You know, when you buy a Park Avenue, you've got quality, so I go on mostly by looks. Because it's just like you meet a person you fall in love. You got to have that car. Boy, says, you must be crazy. What made me mad, so I went down and traded in on a Park Avenue. She's just she's Park Avenue all the way. She's got the reason I'm driving my pickup. She's got the car.
I'm Hermine Ferrigno. My husband and I established New York Hair Company in 1980. We've grown to 6 convenient locations. We service more than 1,800 clients weekly. With our years of training and experience, we introduced precision haircutting to Sarasota. New York Hair Company is one of the most respected names in haircutting. New York Hair means quality service at the most reasonable price.
Today's aerial shots are courtesy of the Goodyear Blimp Stars and Stripes, based out of Pompano Beach, Florida. Captain Dick Esch flying the Goodyear Blimp today out of Sunrise, Florida. There it is. And had an eagle eye view of what happened here just moments ago. TNN Highway Transportation provided by Cedar Ridge RV Center, Bransfield, New Jersey, featuring Winnebago Motorhomes. Call 1-800-988-4884 and see for yourself why Cedar Ridge is the choice of champions. For information on Featherlight trailers, call 1-800-800-1230. Featherlight is the official trailer of NASCAR. There is the car of Ward Burton. After that 1,000-foot slide on its roof and hood, let's go to the garage, Larry McReynolds.
Okay, I'm here with another victim, Hutt. We don't see you on the Busch Grand National Circuit much. Had a good qualifying run, but not where you'd want to be right now.
Well, we certainly didn't, Larry. You know, we had a gear in it that we felt like would be really good at the end of the race, and, you know, I figured I'd have to give up a little bit at the start, but, you know, we kind of lost a lot of spots there, and, you know, them guys got really racing pretty hard out there and got racing too hard too early, and, you know, just one of them things, but, you know, it's... Drugs for Less, Kleenex Forward is really running pretty good. You know, just one of them things.
Okay, well, better luck tomorrow. Well, let's go out to pit road where Glenn Jarrett was one of the top crew chiefs on the Busch Grand National Circuit.
Well, thanks, Larry. You know, immediately after that wreck, some of the members of Ward Burton's crew came down here to the lift and T-pits of Johnny Benson and expressed their displeasure with what happened. But I think there's a little more to it. Let's talk to Steve Bird, the crew chief. What did Johnny say, Steve?
Well, like you said, he says it's 200-mile-an-hour racing out there, and... you know, we'll just try to go to a spot that wasn't there. And Johnny's sorry. Johnny, no way would do it intentionally. Everybody in here knows that. We feel sorry for the Caterpillar crew there. Them guys, we know them real good. We're right beside each other. But if I was Caterpillar, I'd look at him, man. That was awful poor sportsmanship on their part, coming down here hollering, screaming and everything. But Old Amos and the Lipton T Chevrolet is going on.
Okay, no damage to speak of to the front of Johnny's car. Now, some of the other cars that did not have to go to the garage here, but that are making repairs, Tim Fedewa had some right side damage, as did Doug Hevron. Left side damage on David Bonnet's car. Also, Bobby Dodder came in. Didn't look like there was any body damage, but he may have run over some debris. They were checking his car. Tommy Houston, a little damage to his car, and Patty Moise also made a pit stop to check hers over. Other than that, guys are going back to racing soon.
Thanks, Glenn. The initial contact happened in the trioval area, right in full view of everybody on pit road. Tempers will flare.
Well, you know, Mike, when you're running that many cars that close together, you got two or three lines of cars, three and four wide, you never know what's going to happen. The air is moving around tremendously around these cars, and it can suck one into the other, and the driver has no control whatsoever. So in defense of everybody out there, sometimes things get out of control and you can't even help them.
Sure.
You know, I was watching that wreck when it first started up here. And what happens, your normal line through there, you come in down against the wall, and as you come into the dogleg, you start cutting across lanes, and that's exactly what happened. He was coming down towards the preferred line through the dogleg here, and there was a car there, unfortunately.
Yeah, well, the other thing is you try to find out, you know, you look for the quickest line, and there was a gap between him and the cars in front of him. He may have decided to move down and go a different direction, and Johnny wasn't ready for it.
Caterpillar D8 doesn't have a flatter blade than that roof and hood.
That thing is laid back.
Yes, it is.
Mike, let's say something about the roll cage in that car, though. It stayed up, and as you can see, there's still a lot of room where the driver is. Right on the very front part of the roll cage there is down a little bit, but back there where the driver is, it's right in place.
That's the best part.
Let's watch Ford, and let's see if he is, in fact, making a move that would... Johnny Benson would not be ready for and cause Johnny to get into the back of. Here they come down through the tri-oval.
See them coming. Well, they touch right there. They're pretty much running about the same line. I think maybe just that contact there. Your car is real light through there. You can see it jump up. Right here is a good part. You see where he's sliding here? A long time ago, where this black part is, it used to be grass. Right along here, that car would have probably started digging in and flipping end over end right there.
And if it didn't, some of these cars would.
Oh, yeah.
All that black area to the left was grass here a year or two ago.
Yeah, you even see some cars that are going on down that black area and are going to come out ahead of the wreck and not get involved, and that would have never happened if they had to pave all this.
That's right. Here's Glenn.
Guys, we're in Chad Little's pits. They have the RCA DSS dish. We're watching the replays here. One thing that Steve Bird did not say that Johnny Benson told him was that he was not even sure whether he got into Ward or not. He didn't know for sure if they touched. As I'm talking, Benson is going to come down pit road. They are going to check the nose just to make sure that the damage is not too substantial. A little bit of a dent in the car. I'm going to wait and see if I can see him come by here. Just a little chip, a little nick out of the center section of the grill area there. Other than that, I didn't see a problem. Chad Little also in, putting some gas. Jeff Purvis, Michael Waltrip, Mike Wallace, David Green, all these guys taking this opportunity to come in and top their tanks off with fuel right now. No tire changes, fuel only.
So after this fuel stop, everyone will line back up and we'll give you the restart order when we come back to Talladega Live on TNN.
Wet roadways like this inspired Goodyear's newest all-season AquaTread radio, the all-new Goodyear AquaTread 2, with a deeper, wider aqua channel to sweep water away for outstanding wet traction and the new TreadLife compound. Goodyear gives you a 65,000-mile warranty, so you've got wet traction when you need it. The all-new 65,000-mile AquaTread 2, only from Goodyear.
So when I turn the key, it sounds like my starter is going bad. So I figured since I heard about AutoZone, it was as good a place to try as any, right? But get this. I go in there to buy a starter. The guy tells me we need to test my old one first just to make sure that's not the problem. It turns out that it's a solenoid switch. That one little test gave me a big headache. You know, that AutoZone's all right. And when you get service like that, I mean, you don't forget it.
This is the Texaco Haviland stock car. And this is the Texaco Haviland Indy car. And while these cars run on special fuels, we figured it was still a good way to remind you that Texaco Clean System 3 gasolines give your car unsurpassed performance. And Texaco Haviland Formula 3 motor oil and Texaco antifreeze coolant provide complete protection. But if we really wanted you to remember our name, maybe we should have sponsored something slower.
Athlete's foot is a predator. To cure it all, you've got to kill it all. Today, there's Lutrimen AF spray and powder with full prescription strength medicine that kills all causes of athlete's foot. Lutrimen AF, the killer cure.
At Stanley, we test the quality of our sliding mirror doors by opening and closing them over 100,000 times. This doesn't make for great entertainment, but it does make a great closet door. The Accent Mirror Door from Stanley.
Today's exclusive coverage of the Humminbird Fish Finder 500K on TNN is brought to you by Stanley. Since 1843, Stanley has been helping people do things right.
Looks like we're about a lap away from the restart here. The lights are still on atop the safety car. And, our scoring shows Johnny Rumley, who did not pit, as the leader. We'll see how they line up. Jeff Purvis up there after that stop. Mike Waltrip as well. Patty Moise listed as the second place car right now. I believe also she did not stop and also did a nice job of avoiding the incident. Jeff Purvis, Michael Waltrip, Mike Wallace. Then the cars that did stop, Chad Little, Johnny Benson, Jeff Green, Ken Schrader, Joe Nemechek. The top 10 would sit as of right now.
I don't know. I think I would have come in and at least changed tires because there was a lot of debris on the racetrack, and you run around there 8 or 10 laps under caution, you could pick up any kind of little piece of metal or anything. I would have had to stop.
Perhaps so, buddy. The rules for today, though, only two sets of tires allowed to be changed. That's all you're allowed to mount up and have in the pits. NASCAR said if you cut a tire down, they'll give you another one, but if you flat spot it, too bad.
I'd have took one set right now. Anyway.
Okay.
Yeah, well, that's possible, but some of those cars were ahead of that accident, too, and of course, I guess they could run through it when they come back around. Track position, getting up front in this race might be a real bonus.
Let's show you today's AutoZone Tech Fact, brought to you by the more than 1,000 AutoZone stores across America. AutoZone, the best parts in auto parts. Here's Larry McReynolds.
There's been a lot of questions asked about gear ratios. Now, this particular gear is a 290, like most teams will race at Talladega. The question is, where do we get the 290 number? There's 32 teeth on this ring gear. There's 11 teeth on this pinion gear. You take and divide the 11 into the 32 teeth on the ring gear, and you get 2.90. Now, what that means is, for every 2.9 revolutions that the dry shaft turns the pinion gear, it will turn the ring gear one time. Now, the higher the number of the gear, that means the lower the gear ratio. The lower the number, the higher the gear ratio. For example, this 290 at Talladega, most teams will turn their engines around 6,800 RPMs.
Thanks, Larry.
And the other thing that that we need to note is some cars pull a gear, a ratio, a darn.
Easy enough for you to say.
The Rex got me all tore up. A lot of cars only pull with the right rear tire, which is called an open gear. Other cars use a ratchet, which will spin both rear tires when they leave the pit. The right rear tire will spin and smoke when you leave, and you can't get a lot of traction. But if you pull the ratchet gear, then you might break the transmission because the gear ratio is so high.
Which do you run?
We run an open gear, and we like to see the rear tire spin. It's easier on the drivetrain.
Yeah.
Mike, I was just looking at this crowd out there as they get ready to come back and get the green flag. These guys running back in the pack has always been a fear for me here at Talladega. If I could go to the front, best place on this racetrack is definitely number one spot. I tried to lead every lap that I was in the race here because it's hard to run over somebody if there's nobody in front of you.
And you led a bunch out of the race from this incident. Of course, Ward Burton, the car that ended up on its roof, Bobby Hamilton, Rodney Combs, Jim Bound, Randy LaJoy, Randy Porter, Phil Parsons, Hut Strickland, and Curtis Markham. Still running with minor damage or some damage, David Bonnet, Tommy Houston, Doug Hebron, David Green out with the rear end, Tim Fedewa behind the wall making repairs, as is Jason Keller. That's the damage report after this lap 11 crash. Single file restart. Johnny Rumley set to bring them down.
It looked like Benson and Chad Little got together on that restart here just for a second.
And Little got away a bit here. Schrader dipping down to the inside on Jeff Green.
Has anybody seen Mike McLaughlin? Did he start up on the front row?
Yes.
I haven't seen him. He got through the regular
season. There's Schrader now being overpassed by the draft. Boy, if you don't, you pay the price.
Oh, yeah, you got to be in the right spot. You go with the wrong car and you go backwards.
McLaughlin is 17.
Look
three
at this
wide.
Power move here.
Patty Moise got underneath the 25 car of Rumley, and everybody else got underneath Patty Moise.
Well, Jeff Purvis and Michael Waltrip are absolutely flying. They're first and second place cars, and he will come down the front straightaway here. See him lining up behind him. That's Mike Wallace in third place in the 90 car.
Oh, we might have a little tamer race after that incident. I don't think so.
No, they're still going three and four wide. But everybody knows the importance of staying in that lead pack. If you let those first three or four cars get hooked up and pull away from you, then you really got a problem.
And the one everybody's concerned with is Jeff Purvis.
Well, he's had a stout car all weekend long, set on the pole by a significant margin, and he's leading this thing right now. And I think we're going to see him get a little sanity in this race here in a second.
Purvis this morning, is there anybody out there in practice you couldn't pass and drive away from? He said, no.
Yeah, that's a great feeling.
There's Johnny Benson, the 74 car. That was the car that kind of triggered that accident just a second ago. Whether it's his fault or not, we certainly can't make that call, but he's up there in fifth place right at the moment, running quite well.
Purvis leads them down. Michael Waltrip hanging tight to his rear bumper. It looks like a bit of a six-car breakaway. Four wide behind them. Look at this. Oh, please, sort this out.
Boy, that 25 car, he started up front on the restart. He is going straight to the rear and in everybody's way.
Well, that was three wide through there. You see Kenny Wallace sitting there. He's right near the end of this deal. This car is so strong going down the back straightaway. He's closing in on that group right there. 29 there, Steve Grissom. Quite a good runner here.
Yeah, he was leading the race on the last lap at Daytona until they had a big crash here. Chad Little made it through and won the race.
Last lap speed, 189.4. That's up in qualifying
territory right there.
Six cars have now broken away by about three-quarters of a second. Larry McReynolds can tell us about that four car.
Well, I'm going to tell you, I think there's the same concerns about this four car that we in Winston Cup garage here have got about the four car of Sterling Marlins tomorrow. Not only did Runt Pittman build that engine for that
trouble, Larry, trouble. Turn two. One car is spun. Mike McLaughlin, I believe he did catch the wall with the right front, but everybody is going to get through there okay.
We
Well, guys, right before just a half ago, McLaughlin radioed in. There was some smoke coming from his car. They thought that they might have a right side tire rubbing. He may have gotten into that accident just a little bit, but I imagine that he's got a tire tough break. He didn't get back into the pits to check that, but we'll follow up on it, double check. But he did radio in and have a tire rubbing somewhere.
Outside pole sitter McLaughlin into the wall at turn number two, and he was in a big pack of traffic.
Yeah,
let's have a look here.
He's just sideways down there.
He's sideways right on the flat now. As he goes up the racetrack, you see the flaps are up, right front gets into the wall there. Now here's the dangerous part where he comes back down the racetrack. You see all the cars making it by the bottom side, and then a couple went by on the outside. But when he was sitting there sideways, that was a dangerous time.
We're under caution for the second time today here at Talladega. A single car incident at turn two involving outside pole sitter Mike McLaughlin. We'll be right back.
Spitfire earned a United States patent. Spitfire doesn't look like any other spark plug. And the patented Spitfire doesn't work like any other spark plug.
5 extra horsepower by merely installing these plugs. Quicker in the quarter mile. A 4.8% gain in mileage.
There's nothing like a Spitfire. You'll get more power and more mileage, or your money back. Get the guaranteed Spitfire advantage at leading automotive stores from coast to coast.
Pennzoil's Brickyard 400 sweepstakes. 10 grand prizes of both a trip for two to the Brickyard 400 and a 95 Chevy Monte Carlo Z34. Over 80,000 other prizes. Enter wherever Pennzoil is sold or installed by the pros.
Brickyard's the game! Pennzoil's the name!
At AutoZone, most of our customers are folks who like to work on their cars themselves. The ones who come in most often are those who work on cars for a living. Guys like Ed Graven. Now, Ed's garage is in Ogden, Utah, where most of the time you'll find him pulling an engine or sliding under a car. And just about every day, he drives past a half dozen other parts stores on his way to AutoZone. Because Ed knows that when it comes to getting the right part for the right price, there's just no place better than AutoZone.
Some nights, my husband Ben is out there for hours, in spite of his minor arthritis pain. When he has a flare-up, he takes Advil. Nothing's been proven to last longer. He says Advil lets him get back to doing what he loves. And without the pain, he sleeps better. Says he wakes up feeling ready for another day. Advil, advanced medicine for pain.
And relief is even closer at hand with the Advil Easy Open Cap.
Opryland is the official destination of NASCAR. For more information, call weekdays, 615-889-6611. Cleaning up from the Mike McLaughlin incident out in turn number two earlier today, a new Busch Grand National team made their announcement. There's Pete Orr's new ride. Farmer's Choice Fertilizer will back that team.
Well, I like that number, 88. You and I both run that for a while.
Yeah, that's a fast number.
And Eddie Jones, who used to work with Darrell, will lead that team.
Yeah.
So they made their announcement today. They'll run 5 races this year and the entire schedule.
What do you think? Their uniforms will be overalls?
I think Dick Brooks has got the corner
on
that
deal. Oh, he's
got
it. Yeah, I guess that's probably.
Yeah.
That's a pretty car.
Yep. It is. Great car. You know, there's a lot of parity in this division. You got a Chevrolet leading, a Pontiac second, and a Ford third. I'd say, if nothing else, they have great parity in this division anyway.
As long as we say nothing else.
Nobody's ever told Chad Little they didn't have good
tune in tomorrow, folks.
That's right.
David Bonnet is back out after making repairs. Jason Keller is back in the race. And David Green has fixed the rear end and returned from the garage area. So we're getting set for a restart here at lap 25. And in the trial, the green is on.
Mike, the reason they come up next to the wall the way they do is that's to keep anybody from getting by you on the right-hand side, which is where you can pass. So you stay right out next to that wall and force the guy to go by on the inside, and that's illegal. And I think the 17 car may have just violated that rule.
Here comes Terry Labonte down to the inside. Labonte makes the move on Paddy Moise, climbs 1-2 positions. He's got Schrader with him. Uh-oh, here's two of the Winston Cup guys working tag team style. Here they come on the bottom.
Now, Terry Labonte in the 14. They've got a good run down the back straightaway.
Three
now,
wide.
A lot of help there. You see him in the 20 car there. That's
Jimmy Spencer.
Jimmy Spencer. He don't wait on anybody. He's going right to the front.
No, but you know, the interesting thing is, look how perfect he pulls. He pulls out big lead. They draft back up on him and catch him, but boy, he can pull a lead and blast.
Spencer won practice this morning for tomorrow's Winston Cup race.
Yeah.
Here's Labonte in that MW window Chevy down on the inside, gaining some ground as they come past the tri-oval. Jeff Purvis continues to hold this pack in line pretty much. Let's go back to the garage area, Larry McReynolds.
Okay, I'm real glad to be standing here next to Ward Burton. Ward, pretty nasty wreck out there. Can you kind of, first thing, are you okay?
I'm okay. Really not sure what happened. The Caterpillar car, Chevrolet, done a great job. We've gotten up to somewhere in the top 10. Come through the trial and picked up the 3 car. And I must have got a little tap or something from the back end. About the only thing getting me loose at that point. And from there, I tried to get back on the gas and get everybody's way and got a little airborne. But it was days of thunder all over because I could see the pavement right in front of me. Trying to make sure I got out before the fire got to me, but it's one of them rides, you know. Just I'm glad I'm okay, and the Caterpillar car is doing a good job for me. Just one of them things. We'll get them next week.
Okay, well, good luck tomorrow. And Ward assured me that everybody else that had come through the hospital, that they was okay too.
Thanks, Larry. That's good news.
That is good news. There's a Waltrip in the lead right now. Michael
yeah.
Waltrip leads him down the back straightaway with Mike Wallace running in second place in the 90 car.
And what happened to Jeff Purvis?
He pushed up down here in 3 and 4 when he did, but he went back to about 10th place. But I think you'll see him pull himself right back to the lead again if he wants.
Mike, a lot of times when you're drafting, if you get right in on the left-hand corner of the car when you're coming off the corner, it makes the nose push right out towards the wall.
Glenn Jarrett.
Well, guys, Jeff Purvis thinks that he has a tire going down. That's the reason he backed out. The car got extremely loose. He wanted to back up to the tail end of that pack, see if it would stabilize any, but the crew is ready down here. They're all set for him to come in the pits. They're just waiting to do what he says. He says that it's just a problem with the handling. That's the reason he thought that he might have a tire going down. Real loose right now. He's just taking it easy. Got a little raindrop falling right now, but looks like it's just right over me. That's been the story of my life.
Way to go, Glenn.
It sounds like, you know, it kind of sounds like old Eeyore. Thanks for noticing.
Here comes Schrader. Right to the top of the racetrack, way upstairs, third floor. Kenny Schrader around Mike Wallace and looking for Michael Waltrip.
Now, that's, you talked about holding your breath. That's
yes.
When you hold your breath.
Mike, he said if he could miss the big wreck, that he had a good chance. Yellow is out. Must be on the, it's raining just a little bit. It won't last long, though. There's a lot of sunshine behind us here.
This track is so big. It's 2.66 miles around. And it's about a mile and a half from one side to the other. It's so big it can literally rain here in turn one and be sunny and dry in turn four. But there is a bit of rain coming down here at the start-finish line. This could be a big break for Jeff Purvis. If he does have damage on that car, he can stop under caution without losing a lap. We'll be right back to see what happens there and bring you the rest of the tale of this Hummingbird 500K from Talladega after this word.
No trendy health club. No $60 shorts. No bull. SpeedStick's no-nonsense formula gives you 110% protection. Like you, it never quits.
I'm in.
Peerless Faucet didn't come up with the idea for a spout long and high enough to reach over and into large objects. We merely adapted it for the kitchen. High-rise faucet designs by Peerless. Get more out of your faucet than just water.
Today's cars are a technological wonder. So many makes, so many models, so many parts. In the old days, one standard part would fit many cars. Not anymore. The search for someone committed to having the part you need when you need it can be downright treacherous. You need auto parts specialists, like All-Pro and Bumper to Bumper. At All-Pro and Bumper to Bumper, auto parts are our business and our only business. The auto parts specialist. All-Pro and Bumper to Bumper.
Today's exclusive coverage of the Hummingbird Fish Finder 500K on TNN is brought to you by Automotive Marketing, All-Pro Bumper to Bumper, the auto parts specialist.
Jason Keller and his team still trying to do some work on the budget gourmet Chevy there. They had taken off all the front end sheet metal after being involved in that lap 11 incident, and he's behind the wall getting some work done. A few pit stops under caution, most notably Jeff Purvis. Here's Glenn.
Well, guys, they decided to take advantage of this, obviously, and come in and check and see what the problem is. Jeff was telling them that he's actually having to turn the car right as he goes into a turn. Now, that ain't good. That sounds to me like a steering box problem. That happens at Talladega here. Jeff is wanting them also to check the shocks are going to change. All four tires, obviously, put gasoline on it. But they got a problem right now. They're going to send him back out. They didn't get to look at the shocks, but Jeff keeps telling them on the radio there's something else wrong other than tires. We'll stay on top of it.
If I was turning right to get in the corner, I imagine Darrell will agree with this. I'd be beating some spoiler up on that thing. I'd be turning left to get into a left-hand corner. Believe that.
See, what makes that car so fast is he probably had the spoiler on the minimum, which I think is 45 degrees.
Correct.
If you can run the thing down like that in traffic and the car stays stable, then that's obviously the best way to go. But I don't think he can, and he probably had to knock a little blade up on that thing to tighten her up just a little bit, which will slow him down and drag him back to the same speed as everybody else.
And they did push that spoiler up just a bit while he was on pit road. Let's go back to Glenn.
Yes, they did, Mike, and also the right rear tire was going down. It only had about half the air left in it, so that should take care of his problems.
So the caution is a big break for Jeff Purvis. Last year he started on the pole, but it took 91 laps before he was able to lead. Today he's led 19 of the 30 laps thus far. We'll go racing in one lap. We'll be right back.
Too hot in your car? Don't sweat it. Now at Pep Boys, get a cool deal on our air conditioning quick check for just $19.99. Our AC quick check, only $19.99. Come to Pep Boys now. Now at Pep Boys, get any four of our 35,000-mile all-season steel belted tires at an incredible low $109. That's right, any 75 or 80 series, any four, just $109 at Pep Boys now.
Today in local sports, the poor Sheffield Tigers lost 42-3 to the Wakeman Lions, and they're taking it pretty hard. They may never recover from this one, folks. Davey Johnson couldn't connect all day, little Bobby Emerson couldn't find the plate, and even Big John Burke couldn't score.
At today's Pizza Hut, your pizza's right or it's free, guaranteed.
With 43 games left, team spirit's at an all-time low.
Pizza Hut, year after year, America's favorite pizza place.
Takes 5,000 horsepower. Down the quarter mile, less than 5 seconds. Wow. What do you get? NHRA on TNN Motorsports. It doesn't get any closer.
It's Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. It's the great drive-away getaway. Giant auto sale at the Manatee Civic Center. Truckloads of Toyotas, Fords, Chryslers, Plymouths, Jeeps, Eagles, and Suzuki's must go. You can win one of 20 three-day, two-night vacation getaways at over 50 U.S. resorts. Drive-away getaway. Bottom prices. On hundreds of new and used vehicles. 3 days only. This weekend. At the Manatee Civic Center, Palmetto. It's vacation getaway drive-away. Madness. Don't miss it.
Take the ribbon from your hair.
His life inspired his music.
Shake it loose.
And his music made him a legend.
At the end of the night, Belly says,
this is a religious experience.
Like Hey Jude.
July 23rd, the Disney Channel presents Kris Kristofferson, songwriter, A Musical Portrait, only on cable.
On Paragon Cable. More choice, less money.
Getting set for the restart here at Talladega. Both Mark Martin and Tracy Leslie made pit stops back at lap 24 on the second caution. They've charged up into 12th and 13th positions, just out of this top 10.
You know, Mike, if I was Purvis, I'd have come back in and readjusted my spoiler, because once he found out he had a rear tire down, that spoiler being up would slow him down dramatically. So he may or may not run as well as he did, but I think that'll hurt him some.
And he'll restart back of the field as we get the green to restart this race. For the fourth time, this brief caution for rain. And now, Mike Waltrip and Ken Schrader have Jeff Green trying to draft along those three cars. And then a pack, Mike Wallace, Johnny Benson, Chad Little.
I'd say those first six will get hooked up here and just run off and leave everybody else for a while.
I'm sorry, that's not Benson, that's Little car in line. But it is Chad Little just there, back in that sixth position. There's the front three.
Uh-oh, the four car's off.
Further problem. And that was Johnny Benson. I'm sorry, he is in the fifth spot. And that second group has caught the front three, so it's a bit of a six-car break, and then everybody a couple wide behind them.
You see Mike Wallace there in fourth place. He had about a 10, 12-car length. He was behind the first three cars. He run them down on that one straightaway there. He has an extremely fast car, and I really think he'd get through the corners as well as anybody here.
Jeff Purvis telling his crew he's cut down a tire and will pit.
Boy, he's having a terrible time.
Six-car breakaway now. Chad Little hanging on to it, and there's that second pack.
When they race like that right there, Mike, that six in the front are just going away about a second a lap.
Isn't that the neatest thing you can see in your mirror is a bunch of them all fanned out back
especially
there?
Especially if there's about five to go and you're up there in that lead pack and you see everybody behind you racing.
Well, you see Jimmy Spencer there. Everybody's choosing to go to the high side, and it's really slowing them down. If they would really get in a choo-choo train there and run that lead pack down, they probably could catch them. But right now, they're losing time and not following well.
This will help them. Schrader down to the bottom, leaving Mike Waltrip out there on the clothesline, hung out to dry, as we say. And he squeezes back in line, but just barely, back in fourth place. All right, let's go to Glenn Jarrett on the Jeff Purvis story.
The guys, I was in Purvis's crew waiting like they were for Jeff to come in, and he had a right rear tire was completely flat on the rim. He got here, he had no brakes, he went right on by the pits, couldn't stop. So bad day for these guys today. They're pushing him back up pit road. In fact, he's backing the car up pit road right now, but right rear tire's flat. He's already down one lap, and he'll soon be down two.
James Fitch's team runs seven races. They may do a full Busch season next year if the right deal comes along, James says, but here they pick and choose their races and run where they're best, and that includes Talladega, where he's been on the pole the last 2 years.
Well, these radial tires are so mean. In other words, they're so tough, the sidewalls are, that if that tire went flat on him, it could have probably shaken that brake line off of the caliper, and that's why he doesn't have any brakes.
You know, Mike, we're always talking about qualifying at Talladega. Kenny Schrader qualified 25th, and look at him up here in the lead right now, and he won the last race here, so it's not exactly how you qualify here. If you have a good car that handles and really works well with a lot of cars around you, you have an advantage there, not necessarily the way you qualify.
Schrader in number 52, the only former winner in the field today.
Well, not only that, but what did he tell you, buddy, about missing that first big wreck?
That's what he said. If I miss that first big wreck, I'll be leading.
It turned into quite a profit.
Yes.
See, Jimmy Spencer's caught that first six cars there. He's in 20 car there. He's in sixth place right now. He's really working hard.
Big knot of cars there toward the back of that pack. Labonte high outside of that blue 47 of Jeff Fuller. And there's Sadler side by side with Steve Grissom, light blue number 29. And again, Spencer pokes the nose down low in that Fina Ford, number 20. He's going to climb up one spot here in the back straightaway.
Now, that's somebody that you could have to deal with. If Spencer can get up here to the front, you got your work cut out for you.
He got two speeds, wide open, dead still.
From the front to the back of this pack is only a second and a half at 190 miles an hour. From Mark Martin, looking ahead to Johnny Benson. Mark in eighth place.
You know, Hermie Sadler's running really well here today. He's right there with Mark, and he and Tracy Leslie both are running real well at this point in the race.
Sadler could use a good run. He's had only two top five finishes this year.
Yeah, it's his own team, and he's really working hard to get that thing established. Great little driver. Does well today.
The Herminator. That's him. He's really, you see Tracy Leslie going by on the inside, though. He's a little bit quicker in that part of the racetrack.
I think Michael's having some sort of problem. His car looks a lot like Ferguson did there. Maybe that wasn't Michael.
Well, he's got a bumper full of Jimmy Spencer right now.
There was a yellow car back there that went up the hill, but maybe that wasn't Michael. I guess that was Chad Little. That's what it was.
Michael Waltrip for the lead. At Pennzoil Pontiac underneath the AC Delco Chevy of Schrader, and he's going to bring Jimmy Spencer right with him. Spencer comes up high, and Jeff Green number three. Goodwrench car slides underneath, and Mark Martin brings the inside lane along, and everybody's right back to it.
Did you see the way Jeff Green got and slid in front, as you said, of Kenny? Kenny let that happen. Now, there's where an experienced veteran like Kenny Schrader will let him in. You lifted the throttle ever so slightly to let him in. Some other guys might elect not to, and that's when we end up with a problem.
Well, here's Mark, still looking on the bottom side against that fleet of Chevrolets. And the Pontiac on the point. Pontiac, Ford, Chevy, Chevy, Ford.
Well, you have to admit, this is exciting racing.
Yes.
It's just bumper to bumper, and they're running 185 or 89, whatever miles an hour, and they're all over each other. Pretty exciting.
16 cars are in that lead draft.
And if we hadn't lost 16, they'd be right there with them.
Yes, you're right.
That's the only reason they're not more.
There in second place right now. He's very happy with that spot. It looks like Michael Walter may have a little bit faster car, and he's just happy to be in that draft right to where he's at. Unless Mike Wallace gets up there, he's running so well, he's moving by Schrader as we speak there on the inside.
See, Spencer got up there, and he came from way back, and now he's in second place. He's going to sit here a little while enjoying himself, and in a minute he'll get impatient to and he's going to go by Michael.
And this is really the benefit of drivers like Kevin LePage and Jeff Fuller and some of the fellas up there that don't have a lot of 200 mile an hour experience. Being able to work this draft, run a little, learn a little here.
They can watch the Chess Masters. These guys do it every week almost on major speedways, and once they learn the moves, they can do it just like the guys that are leading this race right now.
Jeff Purvis has taken his car behind the wall, and here comes Spencer for the lead. Down on the bottom with Jeff Green.
You know, we have to, you got to give a call to Jeff Green too. He hadn't run a lot of races here in Talladega. Of course, he's got an experienced crew chief and a great car, but nevertheless, he's doing a great job for a guy that doesn't have a lot of laps on this racetrack.
Second race that Spencer has led this year. Chad Little
comes
down into Mike Wallace, and Mike Wallace is going to take the slide. Two cars in the wall. Mark Martin's one of them.
92 car here. Here he comes. 29 car.
Everybody else gets whoa down and away. Larry Pearson took a long slide, as did Steve Grissom. And Grissom's car, the right side's pretty torn up.
But there's the 92 car, because of this pavement down here again, he's going to drive away. I don't know what happened there. I saw the impact, but I don't know what happened to Mark.
Before the replays, Glenn Jarrett is with Jeff Purvis out of the race. Glenn?
And what I think was a very smart decision, obviously a problem with the car, Jeff, you just decided to park it for the day.
Well, we had a great race car. You know, people really don't know how good this Kodak Fun Saver car was going to be today. I cut a tire down leading the race, and luck was on our side for a few minutes there when the rain came out. And then we went back out and blew out another tire. And I don't know what happened. Undoubtedly, we picked up some debris real fast because I blew out a tire before the race ever even got started. And it broke the brake lines and just tore up enough stuff under the car just to park it.
Well, like I said, I think a wise decision that they made not to take a chance with the car again. Jeff will be back another day. Back upstairs to Mike.
Thanks, Glenn. You see Mark Martin, who has a little bit of a limp. And let's show you what happened as he and Mike Wallace battled for track position right in the middle of your screen here. You'll see the move down to the right.
What happened? The 23 car, the 90 car takes an evasive move to the inside, and 23 gets into him. Now, I don't know where Mark is.
Backing up on the outside as we watch Mike Wallace in this view.
Because Mark was really, you know, he wasn't involved.
You see Pearson there just going into the grass on the inside there. He did not damage the car whatsoever. He just took a long slide.
And Grissom got into the outside wall. Yeah. Let's see if we can pick up Mark Martin in a second view here.
There's a... Oh, he got hit by the 29 car. Okay.
Yep.
That's what happened.
There they are.
Yeah.
As Grissom came up to try to avoid Chad Little and the 90 car, Mike Wallace, he got into Mark.
Mark hit really hard on the outside there. And what happens, you've seen him limping a little bit. A lot of times your legs will get up into, like, the clutch pedal, and it'll really give you a whack.
Yeah. It hit his...
Here's a different angle.
Again, the 90 car just pulled really down in front of Chad Little. It's kind of what it looks like. Looked like he was trying to block him, keep him going by, maybe.
Chad had made a pretty abrupt move there. to drop down two lanes all the way underneath Mike Wallace, and it looks like just did not clear him.
That was two guys racing for the same spot, I think.
Well, you could see the roof flaps on the 90 car of Mike Wallace really worked that time because they popped up the minute the car turned sideways.
All right, let's go to Chad Little's pit. Here's Larry.
Okay, Chad brings the car in. Looks like he's going to probably come in for two tires. David Green's in behind him. They jacked the right side up. No adjustments made on the car. Two right side tires. Looking at the front end, don't see any damage whatsoever on it at all. Again, no adjustments. Filling it up with fuel. Two tires. And he's down and away. Jeff Green is going to change four tires. Johnny Benson just changed two right side tires. But Chad Little wins the race off pit road.
Jimmy Spencer getting out ahead of the two Busch Grand National point leaders. And that's how we'll restart. So we'll be back to Talladega right after this.
At AutoZone, most of our customers are the kind of people who like to work on their cars themselves. That way they save money and they know the work's done right. Of course, when they come to AutoZone, they know they're going to find the right part for the right price. But sometimes what they're looking for is just a little advice. And that's okay, because we don't put a price tag on it. You see, at AutoZone, we take pride in taking care of our customers. And we've learned that when you treat folks right, they keep coming back.
Get free, that's not us! I guess this still matter about the strike, huh?
Telling me?
What do we do?
There's only one thing to do. Take them off of Vincent.
What? Are you nuts? You know how much that would cost?
We'll take them to the Pizza Hut lunch buffet. You can get all the pizza, pasta, and salad you can eat for just $3.99.
What's $3.99 times 50,000?
$200,000.
How much you got on you?
About $100,000. I got two.
I got a quarter mil.
Yeah, you got change?
One of these hammers is jacketed in high-impact polycarbonate. The other one is broken. The fiberglass jacketed hammer from Stanley.
He's your best friend, and he's also killing your back. If nothing seems to help, try Dohn's. It relieves back pain no matter where it hurts. Dohn's has an ingredient these pain relievers don't have. Dohn's, the back specialist.
Electrodes, more power, more electrodes, faster start.
Suddenly, everybody has a new spark plug idea promising instant higher performance. But one new plug's idea is higher performance that lasts. Introducing Autolite Double Platinum. Platinum on both sides of the gap for faster starts and more power every time. Platinum to platinum firing for guaranteed peak performance, long after other ideas have peaked out. Autolite Platinum and now Autolite Double Platinum. More precious metal for your precious metal.
Today's exclusive coverage of the Humminbird Fish Finder 500K on TNN is brought to you by Allied Signals Autolite Spark Plugs. Guaranteed for 2 years, no matter how far you go.
And giving these aerial views from Talladega, the Goodyear Blimp Stars and Stripes. The Goodyear Blimps now in their fourth decade of live sports coverage. Welcome to Talladega. Getting lined up for the restart here. Patty Moise is leading. First time she's led on the Busch Series since the Road Atlanta road race in 1987, where she sat on the pole. She has her Dial Purex machine in the lead. Let's take you now to today's Innovation in Motion. It's brought to you by Peerless Faucet. Get more out of your faucet than just water. Here's Larry McReynolds.
Okay, all year I've talked about sensible innovations that help the cars on the racetrack, but it's 120 degrees down here. Look at me. It's 100% humidity. So we're going to figure out how we're going to keep cool. You know, we got this one box, a little cool air port on me here. I got Nelson Crozier sock full of ice. Keep me cool on the neck. Little lemon ice. But you know, it's hard for me to have my hands free. So in that case, I've stopped by the Chad Little Pits and just get a little fanning. A little harder, girls. Come on, a little harder. A lot nicer.
You know, and they're always telling us what a tough time they have down on pit road.
Fran, turn the air conditioning up in the booth here just a little bit, would you? While we go to Glenn with Steve Grissom.
Well, thanks, Mike. I've moved into the Busch Grand National garage area here, and Steve Grissom has just crawled out of his car. You see the rear end damage there. Steve, what happened?
A couple cars got together there in front of us, and unfortunately, Channel Lock Monte Carlo got caught up in it. I tell you, the guys had a good car here today, and You know, this bush race here at Talladega is awful exciting, and, you know, it's just getting yourself into position. I tell you, we had got up to the front and found ourselves in the back and got back up to the, toward the front, and, you know, it's been a lot of fun. But, like I say, the guys on this team, Chanelock, hey, it's fun to come back and do this.
Well, as you can tell, it's been an up-and-down day. Right now, he's down. Just a quick update on Mark Martin. I talked to one of his crewmen. They said that Mark was okay. He was talking to him. He just had a little slight limp. He bumped his leg, buddy.
Tommy Houston has been overcome by the heat. He appears to be out of the Red Devil, number six. It's Scott Houston putting the wind in it back up, so relief driver for Tommy.
They had some damage on that car, so it may be that some of the inner panels or something are knocked out of it.
Boy, that doesn't, with the windows in these cars like that, if that inner panel, that's on the inside of like the right rear tire there, you see it has damage there. Probably knocked that open in there, and every bit of the heat and smell off that right rear comes right up in the car with you.
There's your leader, Patty Moise, as we get set to go back to green. Let's go to the garage and Glenn.
Well, guys, you're getting a look at the terrific impact that hit Mark Martin's car. This thing has been shortened. Now, you can see there's about 5 feet over here on the right, on the left side fender. It's shortened down to about a foot, foot and a half over there on the right side. That is a tremendous impact, and I suspect he's got more than a slight lift than this. This car is trashed.
It's already been to the crusher.
Boy, yeah. Oh boy, he's lucky to walk away. My flesh just have a little bit of a limp.
We're getting set to go back to green. 45 laps are complete here. The longest, and it looks like the most carnage-filled bush race of the season.
Boy, it is.
Here at Talladega today.
How many laps have we run here?
45.
45, and we're done. Goodness.
Patty Moise the leader. Jimmy Spencer is second. Chad Little is third. Johnny Benson in fourth place. Joe Nemechek fifth. Sixth is Tracy Leslie. Seventh, Hermie Sadler. In eighth is Kevin LePage. Ninth is Dale Fishline. If any driver has the name to go to victory lane for the Fishfinder race, it's Fishline. Jeff Green is 10th. Elton Sawyer 11th. 12th is Michael Waltrip. 13th, Kenny Schrader. 14th, Bobby Dotter. 15th, Kenny Wallace. Then it's Terry Labonte, the 75 of Rick Wilson, Robbie Reiser, Jeff Fuller, Mike Wallace, Johnny Rumley, Tommy Houston, Larry Pearson are all on the lead lap.
Teddy Moise got a good start there, leading Jimmy Spencer as they come out of turn two and down towards the back straightaway there. See Spencer taking the high line, and just behind him, you see Chad Little in the 23 car.
And a good boost for Patty Moise, who has not had a top dozen finish yet this season.
Well, you know, both our point leaders, Vincent and Chad Little, have been in a somewhat of a compromising position here a couple of times. Vincent early on, and then Chad just recently.
But both of their cars are unscathed, and they now run with Jimmy Spencer for the front spot.
Over to the lead.
See them all lining up behind Spencer, and Patty Moise just caught on the outside there. She's dropping many positions.
But this, buddy, the tri oval is one of the most treacherous parts of this racetrack. It's not banked a lot, and the speed through there is 190 miles an hour. So if anybody touches anybody there, you don't have the banking to hold the car down like you do in the corners, and that's why we see a lot of wrecks there.
Watch Michael Waltrip, that bright yellow car, shooting up the outside, gaining three spots, and now dropping into line. Now to the inside comes the Pennzoil Pontiac. Michael has a fast car, and he has Schrader with him.
Boy, I tell you, with Schrader right on his back bumper, it looks for him to come towards the front in a hurry. You see him going by everybody now on the bottom side of the racetrack. That's Kenny Wallace there, number eight car going through.
Dale Fishline and Terry Labonte. Here's Michael, tacked up under Patty Moise here on the low side.
Push Patty right back to the front.
Yep.
Pretty good job today, guys. That's one of her best runs in a long time.
Yes.
No, she come down here one time in a prepared car and run 223 miles an hour, so this isn't her first time to run fast. She's pretty good on this type of racetrack.
Ran 217 miles an hour in a Mike Laughlin Buick. I think it was Mike Laughlin.
Yeah.
It's a Buick.
It's a Buick.
Touchy, touchy. I mean, 217, that's still getting on with the program, believe you me.
Here goes Michael down on the inside.
Jeremy Mayfield has relieved Tommy Houston. His Busch car did not qualify for this race. He was standing by. He'll be in the Houston Cup race.
I got a feeling if those inner panels are out, he won't be out there very long. That's so uncomfortable.
Wow, I guarantee you one thing. Kenny Schrader was very lucky there. Your brother just made a little move there. He had to check up just a little bit but he didn't hook him in the left field that we've seen several times in the dog leg.
They're going after Spencer, and they've got him. Michael Waltrip goes to the lead. Here comes Schrader up to the second spot, and Chad Little wants third. So they continue to battle on the point here at the world's fastest speedway. We'll be right back.
Today's cars are a technological wonder. So many makes, so many models, so many parts. In the old days, one standard part would fit many cars. Not anymore. The search for someone committed to having the part you need when you need it can be downright treacherous. You need auto parts specialists, like All-Pro and Bumper to Bumper. At All-Pro and Bumper to Bumper, auto parts are our business and our only business. The auto parts specialist. All-Pro and Bumper to Bumper.
Hey, you know my crew spends hundreds of hours building those 5,000 horsepower motors? I can explode one in 5 seconds. And when that happens, nobody eats. That's why my guys won't run anything but Fram fillers. You know, Fram gets the nasty stuff out of the oil, so I can go to the other end with my candles lit. And you know, that's in about 5 seconds, nearly 300 miles an hour. You can look at these guys and see they eat pretty near every day.
If you're the type who likes to live on the edge, you'll also want to live wide.
If you love racing, come to the track or come to TNN's Salute to Motorsports at Opryland USA, Nashville, Tennessee. Step into the thrilling world of motorsports. Meet drivers. See classic cars, race cars, and exhibits. Shop for collectibles and spend two fun-filled days at Opryland Theme Park, all for just $37.95. So be a winner. Come to the TNN Salute to Motorsports at Opryland USA. For more information, call 615-889-6611. Welcome back live to Talladega, Alabama, where the hits just keep on coming. Coming down the front straightaway, battling for position, Hermie Sadler and Bobby Dotter got together. Let's show you what happened. Coming out of the tri-oval, watch for the yellow car on the bottom of your screen. That is Hermie Sadler. The blue and white car is Dotter. Here they come out of the tri-oval.
You see Hermie start over there, and there's a car there. That triggered the whole thing there.
Boy, Fishline, the dark blue car, just misses that one and goes, and Sadler goes to the fence.
Wow.
There's Mike Wallace squeezing through again.
Yep, Jeff Fuller right through there. Here's another look at it. Watch the bottom of your screen, the yellow car.
Yeah, he just moved over. I'm sure his spotter may have told him there was a hole there and he could get into it. There was a hole there, and he couldn't get into it.
Darryl, you hear about spotters all the time, but I always made sure there wasn't anybody over here at 200 miles an hour before I pulled over. I didn't care what they said. I would kind of look in the mirror and make sure where I was at.
Now, from the in-car camera, if you were there, here's how it would be.
Oh, boy.
From Elton Sawyer's car. And so we are under caution once again. It's the fifth one of the day for Hermie Sadler's crash here at the start-finish line. We'll be right back.
It's Racing Roundup.
Welcome, Phil Parsons, driver of the number 99 Luxair Chevrolet. Phil, ready for the big race?
Don't think I'm going.
What?
You know how hot it gets in that car.
Oh, sure, Phil, but you're...
Comfortable right here at home. With high-performance Luxair Central Air.
But what about your fans?
Fans? You don't need fans in a house with Luxair Central Air.
Thank you, Phil Parsons.
Folks, look in the yellow pages for your Luxair dealer or call 1-800-LUXAIR.
Hey, I like to save money as much as the next guy. But what are the odds that there's going to be a sale on the parts you need when your car breaks down? Hey, it's not going to happen. That's why I go to AutoZone. I mean... Sure, you could wait around for a couple weeks and maybe beat their price by a few pennies someplace else. But I don't want to wait for a sale when I need a part. No, Well, what more could you ask for?
Today's exclusive coverage of the Humminbird Fishfinder 500K on TNN is brought to you by the more than 1,000 AutoZone stores across America. AutoZone, the best parts in auto parts.
At Talladega, Alabama, they continue to go by the wayside one by one. Early in the race, it was 15 at a time, and now it's in the ones and twosies. There's Hermie Sadler's car. Young fella from Emporia, Virginia, has had only two top five finishes this year. Had a good run going, but got up into Bobby Dotter and then to the wall.
Boy, Dotter did an outstanding job of saving his car. That could have been a 8 or 10 car pileup too. Dotter really did a good job of hanging on.
Darrell, that was incredible. I don't know how that was a one-car wreck. I really don't.
No, I don't either, buddy. That could have been a whole lot worse.
So they're going to line up here for the restart. Get ready to go. Hardly anyone on the lead lap made a pit stop. Let's take a break while they run this final caution lap. We'll be right back to green.
Is the gray in your mustache or beard making you look too old? Now there's Just for Men Brush-In Color Gel, specially for the hard-to-color hair of mustaches and beards. This brush-in gel stays put to penetrate hard-to-color hair. In 5 minutes, rinse. Your mustache or beard blends with your natural hair color, and it won't fade or wash out.
Now that's a lot better.
Just for Men Color Gel, from the leader in men's hair coloring.
The newest way you can cure athlete's foot is the way doctors cure it. With the same ingredient they've prescribed millions of times. It's new Prescription Strength Desinex. Nothing cures athlete's foot better. New Prescription Strength Desinex, the doctor's cure.
At Stanley, we test the quality of our sliding mirror doors by opening and closing them over 100,000 times. This doesn't make for great entertainment, but it does make a great closet door. The Accent Mirror Door from Stanley.
Put yourself in the boots, the hat, the jeans, the chaps of a rodeo cowboy on a hot Friday night in Mesquite, Texas. Get your vicarious thrills right here on Championship Rodeo every Friday night on TNN.
Shopping made easy at Thomas Hole Square with the Hobby Stop and Kelly Vacuum and Sewing Center, with one of the largest selections of vacuums and sewing machines in Bradenton, representing a full line of sewing machines, threads, notions, and parts. To repair most makes and models, see Kelly Vacuum and Sewing Center first. For the ultimate stock car racing, check in at the Hobby Stop. We'll set you up with everything you need to take it to the limit. We also house almost every hobby imaginable. We've controlled planes, cars and boats, trains, rockets, models, and much more. Visit the Hobby Stop in Kelly Vacuum Sewing Center in Palmasola Square.
Take the ribbon from your hair.
His life inspired his music.
Shake it loose.
And his music made him a legend.
At the end of the night, Belly says,
this is a religious experience.
Like Hey Jude.
July 23rd, the Disney Channel presents Kris Kristofferson, songwriter, a musical portrait, only on cable.
On Paragon Cable, more choice, less money.
Back for the restart as they roll off to turn number one, Michael Waltrip, Kenny Schrader, Chad Little, that yellow car in third, Jimmy Spencer in fourth, Johnny Benson, the point leader, and Jeff Green in number three. Those six cars with a little bit of a break here. Poole tries to run them down to the back straightaway.
I got a winning combination. You take a car that's not wrecked too bad, but won't keep up with the rest of them, stay about a half lap behind all day, and maybe you'll win this race.
That or the pace car has a good shot at it today.
I'm telling you, Elmo is going to pull off a win.
Six cars, then Kevin LePage and Tracy Leslie trying to draft up on them. Patty Moise in ninth. Joe Nemechek in tenth.
Like people probably sitting at home saying, why don't they just line up and follow each other for a while? But the way the cars work and the way the draft works, it's almost impossible to do. You get such a head of steam of such a run at the guy in front of you, you've got to pull out and go around him or you're going to hit him in the rear end.
You can see what happens when you get out of line. Kenny Schrader went from second place all the way back to fifth now.
Yeah. Ooh.
Whoa,
Jimmy Spencer got in the back of Chad Little. Just as you said, Darrell, you're running in that draft, you pull up, you're either going to hit him or pass him.
That's right. If you don't pull out it quick enough, you're going to hit the guy in front of him.
Spencer did a little of both.
This little of both.
And Chad Little gets shuffled back to fifth.
Well, he's getting his heart rate way up right now, and as soon as he gets calmed back down, he'll try to get back up toward the front.
You know who's not playing to your strategy?
Terry Labonte. Back there, 10th spot, riding along. Let's ride along. Let's stay in the draft. Let them have fun up there.
Well, there's Labonte. You're exactly right. And I guarantee you that he'll be a factor before today's over.
That white car right in the middle of your screen is Terry Labonte.
Kind of cruising along there.
Cruise control.
He's got her own cruise.
Everybody has their special place, but I think your brother right now, Michael Walters, is in the place I'd rather be. Out in front, and let everybody else worry about shuffling around. They're back in a tight spot there, and anything can happen when these cars running side by side in front.
Yeah, you see Kenny Wallace way around on the outside. That's a touchy move. You got to be sure that guy knows you're there.
Up front, here comes Spencer once again.
Do you see that move?
Oh, Spencer see? Loose there, coming through the dog leg. You see the back of the car, Darrell, it was moving back and forth. Yeah. He's very loose out in front.
He is not going to give that guy in front a chance to make an evasive action. You don't move as quick as he does.
Yeah, two good movie titles come to mind. Evasive action and sudden impact.
Sudden impact, yeah.
There's Jason Keller's car, minus the nose, down on the apron, cruising for points.
Here comes Johnny Benson on the inside, trying to take the lead away from Spencer.
Are you just helpless when you're the first car and that happens?
Oh, yeah. You're just sitting there, and all you can do is really kind of try to take the guy behind you, line away a little bit, slow him down somehow. But he's got to hit his steam up. He's going to go past him.
Now, let me correct that. Was Curtis Markham cruising for rookie points. Jason Keller's car is in the garage still.
Yeah, Markham was in that earlier accident. Right. I thought he had quite a bit of damage, but at least he's back out there.
There goes Jeff Green trying to make a move going into turn one to take the lead.
Everybody wants to lead at least a lap. There are no points for leading a lap here as there are in the Winston Cup Series. Halfway next time by.
Boy, there's an unusual sight. Spencer, he had to let up to not hit Benson in the rear end.
And here comes Schrader.
He's mellowing, Darrell.
He's mellowing in
this. All right. Is this as much fun as it looks like it is?
Oh, it's more fun. Believe you me. From up here, it's air racing. Out there, it's just a lot of fun. Being in the right place and setting a guy up for a couple of laps to make that great move towards the front. And when it really works for you, you go, yes, everything worked the way I wanted it to.
See, you got to understand something, Mike. When you're driving that car, you're in that car with your helmet on, you have tunnel vision. You can't see everything we see. You don't see all those cars moving around. You don't see what's going on behind you all the way back. You just see all in your own little world, and it doesn't look near as scary when you're out there as it does sitting up here.
It looks like a lot of fun.
It can be. When it all works right, it can be a lot of fun.
Here we go, two by two again.
Everybody back to the front. Cut the deck in half, and now shuffle.
Now, you wonder why they pull away like that. Michael Waltrip right now thinks his car is a little bit quicker, so he does not want to slow the car down by having a side draft off the car real close to him. So he's trying to break the draft. As you see, he didn't have the car he thought he had.
No, look at Kevin LePage up there, right in the fourth spot, man. Right on Schrader.
He's too
close.
Here's
Stanley Tools mid-race report brought to you by Stanley since 1843. Stanley helping people do things right. 10 leaders in the first half of this race, 16 lead changes. I think we'll see more than that number in the second half. Yeah, average speed slowed by all those caution flags.
LePage I know he couldn't help it, but he was way too close to Kenny because just the air alone could have lifted Kenny's car up and made it get real loose on him and caused him to spin out. So I know you got to get close, but that was a little bit too close.
But in fairness to LePage, has he raced here enough to know that?
No, probably not. He's been home making teddy bears for most of the day. I don't think he knows that.
And we're back to single file among the front six. Look at Spencer climb the hill there. And back behind them, it's too wide with Tracy Leslie on the bottom of Chad Little, Larry Pearson, Johnny Benson.
Well, we're getting a little too grouped up here again to suit me. I'd like to see him get some more single file. Cars are just moving around too much to be that to run that close together.
You know, have you ever noticed Darrell when he gets up here? Now I watched him in practice today, and he was out there running, coming up through people, three wide, going into turn one, drove to the bottom, took the lead of the whole group, and now he sits up here like a Sunday school teacher. I wouldn't do that. I don't think I'd try that. You kidding, big boy?
It doesn't look like that out there. You know that. It just looks odd here.
Buddy, what I like too is when you sit up here and drive, you don't shake your fist out the window of the booth.
Right.
No. Those are days gone by.
Let's go to Larry McReynolds.
Thanks, Mike. I talked to Jimmy Spencer's crew chief, and just as y'all saw, Jimmy, when he's out front leading with not a car in front of him, the car is a little bit loose, especially getting down in the corner. Now, they're on the minimum 45 degrees spoiler. Next pit stop, they're going to put that fuel in it to try to get to the end, and they are going to put some spoiler in it. They're just a little concerned on how much spoiler to put in it, because obviously the more spoiler they put in it, the more it hurts it on the straightaway, but they have definitely got to tighten that race car up if they want to win this race.
Spencer's number 20, the Fina Loop for
Hey.
And back straight away, out of turn two, 200 miles an hour. On the lead lap, 22 cars.
You see Benson dropping back there just a second ago. He's running second place. You see Kevin Page getting passed right now by Jeff Green. And here comes Spencer on the bottom side. Loose or not, he's still up front.
Yeah, I mean, loose is fast, but it's also pretty treacherous. And Chad Little gets the nose of that Thunderbird stuck on the back end of him. It could cause him some problems.
Jimmy Spencer won the Winston Cup race here last year and at Daytona in July. His last Busch Series win, 1992 at Rougemont, North Carolina.
You know, we talk about Jimmy Spencer doing this and that, but he's good television. I don't care what anybody says. If he's out there and that car is capable of going to the front, he is going up there.
He would make a car owner nervous, I know that. especially me.
He drove for Buddy for some time.
I'll tell you what, he did a good job in Daytona. He came from the very last spot, went down and went all the way to second place, and he got involved in that. But he was going to the front, and that's what I told him. I said, bring the steering wheel back if you can run good, boy.
That's it. All right, Chad Little to the bottom this time on David Green.
Chad got his heart rate settled back down, and he's going to try to get back up front again.
Two Fords line up against the Pontiac of Michael Waltrip. And everybody goes too wide behind them.
That's the worst thing that happens to Jimmy if he's loose, because those cars on the outside of him will really make him looser. They'll try to suck the back of that Ford right around.
64 laps complete. We're just past halfway here at Talladega. As they fan out one more time, Michael Waltrip leads here. As they get three wide, we'll be right back.
Over a million people each week walk into AutoZone, and taking care of them means having what they need when they need it. That means stocking a lot of parts for a lot of cars. Now, nobody can stock everything, but we stock more than most. And how do we know which ones to carry? That's easy. We listen to our customers, because nobody knows better about what you want than you. So the next time you walk through that door, you might think of yourself as a customer, but we think of you as the boss.
Pennzoil's Brickyard 400 sweepstakes. 10 grand prizes of both a trip for two to the Brickyard 400 and a 95 Chevy Monte Carlo Z34. Over 80,000 other prizes. Enter wherever Pennzoil is sold or installed by the pros.
Brickyard the game! Pennzoil the name!
No trendy health club. No $60 shorts. No bull. SpeedStick's no-nonsense formula gives you 110% protection. Like you, it never quits.
By minute.
He's your best friend, and he's also killing your back. If nothing seems to help, try Dones. It relieves back pain no matter where it hurts. Dones has an ingredient these pain relievers don't have. Dones, the back specialist.
Electrodes, more power, more electrodes, faster start.
Suddenly, everybody has a new spark plug idea promising instant higher performance. But one new plug's idea is higher performance that lasts. Introducing Autolite Double Platinum. Platinum on both sides of the gap for faster starts and more power every time. Platinum to platinum firing for guaranteed peak performance, long after other ideas have peaked out. Autolite Platinum and now Autolite Double Platinum. More precious metal for your precious metal.
Today's exclusive coverage of the Humminbird Fishbinder 500K on TNN is brought to you by Allied Signals Autolite Spark Plugs. Guaranteed for 2 years, no matter how far you go.
Turn two, three wide for the lead, and they break it off. Folks, since we've been gone, we've been holding our breath.
Two different drivers have had a shot at the front spot. Jeff Green with a little nudge, or rather gave little Michael Waltrip a little nudge. They're three wide again. Look at LePage.
Chad Little coming with him here in the 23 car. Spencer's caught out in the middle there, but he drove right back to the bottom and took over the lower lane.
Anybody in this pack could lead this race at any time.
Well, yeah, not only that, but they've been running the green for a while now. The tires are going to start wearing a little bit, and the fuel load's going to go off, and these cars are going to get light in the rear end, so they got to be careful when they get real close to each other like we've seen here at time or two.
Good fourth place there. That Satellite Technology Group car, Dale Fishline. Dave Marcus is crew chief. It's the first race he's run all year. He's pedaled it up to fourth place.
Mike, he come out in the very back of the field just a second ago. He's drafted by everybody and brought that car in the top five now.
Interesting story there in the engine department. I said, whose motor is that? He says, well, Ray Zaruba, who does Dave Marcus's in-house motors, and Mike Fryer and Ben Barnes all contributed to putting this engine combination together. He says, and it works.
Well, I'll say he's got some tremendous speed in that car.
Ooh, Kenny Schrader went right across in front of Jeff Green just then. Went way up high, like the car might be pushing just a little bit getting in the corner.
Well, this is, of course, Fishline is moving itself right to the front. It'd be neat if Fishline won the Hummingbird race, wouldn't it?
There.
I like that.
Now, Jimmy Spencer has fallen back, and this pack has broken in two. Larry, what's up?
They pulled some tape off the water opening a while ago and got it cooled down. Actually got it cooled down too much. Now the oil temperature is running over 230 degrees. Starting to lose a little power. He's just going to try to give it some air and see if he can't cool it down just a little bit.
Tracy Leslie's into the back straightaway. Spencer over there.
Jimmy Spencer came up and got into Jeff Fuller, and right behind them, Tracy Leslie shot off the racetrack. Something happened there. And caution will be out. The sixth caution, most ever in the history of this race. They come back to the flag. Schrader in front, Michael Waltrip, Jeff Green, Terry Labonte, Dale Fishline. And we're back under yellow once again for Tracy Leslie.
Well, Spencer was going back through the field there for some odd reason, and I think his car just finally got so loose he was having to back up, and I don't know if something, I didn't see the accident, so we'll see what happened.
Let's have a look here. Now watch, Spencer up just nudging Fuller, and there around goes Leslie.
Well, what happened there? It looked like Spencer got into Jeff Green just a little bit, and they checked up a little bit and got nudged from behind and turned everybody into the inside there.
Yeah, I think that was Tracy was trying to be evasive and ended up taking the blunt of the thing.
Darrell, how much of a difference is it running at 190 miles an hour compared to when you run Charlotte, some of these other tracks, 170 to 190, how big a jump is that?
Well, see,
what
here
the car will do.
You never let off the gas here. So this is a momentum. These engines have restrictor plates on them. You got to keep your momentum up. If you lift out of the throttle, you'll go to the back. Everybody knows this. So you stay wide open all the time. Might even use the brake to slow the car down, but don't let off the gas. That's why they run so close together. That's why we have these accidents the way we do. They bump each other, and you can't do that at 190 miles an hour.
Buddy, is it that easy to just overcorrect?
Well, what it really, I mean, like coming out of that corner over there, you're watching the car in front of you, and all of a sudden he slows just a little bit, just for a second. I mean, you're 3-6 inches off his back bumper. You wham right in the back of him and turn him around because the car is light coming out of the corner there.
It's like Bristol, Tennessee. We run so close together there that when something happens in front of you, you can't avoid it. And that's what this is like at 190 miles an hour.
Now, don't you use a different steering box here at a track like this so that you don't, when you turn the wheel like that, make such a sharp move?
Well, a lot of people run a slow box, but anymore, I think a lot of them are like 17 to 1. They're really not that slow, but they're very active, and the thing you don't ever do on a major speedway is just turn it real sharp, because if you do, you're out of here.
Well, they get to wobbling. That's what happens to them, if you know what a wobble is.
Somebody just spun out in the pits there. It looks like Kevin LePage spun all the way around. He did it in the pits all there.
Well, we used to see that a lot here, buddy, before we had the pit road speed. I haven't seen that much lately, but you see that a lot here in Talladega.
And LePage has damage to the front of his car.
Wow. What did he hit?
A green machine. He might have been in that Tracy Leslie jam up there. Maybe we'll get another chance to see it. Let's review what happened on these caution flag pit stops. First, here's Glenn.
As I'm down here at the very far end of pit road going down toward the start-finish line, Johnny Benson, Chad Little, and Jeff Green, all three took on two tires and fuel. Chad Little had to have his windshield cleaned, and I got a big glass of water, a big bottle of water. Chad had a lot of oil on the windshield. They claimed that it came from the number 20 car. There was a report that they were leaking fluid a while ago, but reports died down, so he must have leaked it all over Chad's front glass. Larry?
I'm down here at the entrance of pit road where Michael Waltrip and Jimmy Spencer's pit, and Michael Waltrip come in, took on two right side tires, made no adjustments. Guys really had a good pit stop, and he was away in a hurry. Jimmy Spencer, again, running a little bit hot now, even on the water. They raised the hood. They made a smart move. They got to cure the problem they've got first before they worry about the race car. They did get it full of fuel, got it cooled down with water. Now I think they're going to come back in and get those tires on. The thing now is everybody can go the distance here on fuel, so I'd say pit stops are probably near the end.
Thanks, Larry. 46 laps to go here at Talladega as the line back up from this caution period and tow Tracy Leslie's car back to the garage area. We'll be right back.
If you don't replace your air and oil filters regularly, you might as well drive your car off a cliff, because dirt can really mess up an engine. Fram Extra Life air filters and Fram Extra Guard oil filters keep out dirt best to protect your engine. Fram, America's number one premium brand. Pay a little now for a lot later. Get a $2 rebate on Fram air filters at participating retailers.
We put these glass walls on the course at Road Atlanta to demonstrate the wet traction and performance of the Goodyear Eagle Aqua Tread. Racing-inspired dual aqua channels sweep water away for outstanding wet traction. Broad shoulders add aggressive grip for precise cornering. Its unique tread compound helps you stick to the road. You get the performance of an Eagle, the wet traction of an Aqua Tread. Eagle Aqua Tread, only from Goodyear.
When the job is tough, you need the best. And when you need the best, you reach for Channel Lock. For the power. The precision. For just plain counting on, there's only one. Channel Lock. Be sure you're getting genuine Channel Lock tools. Look for this trademark.
NASCAR fans, don't give up racing excitement at the end of the season. Join us December 4th through 8th on the Big Red Boat as TNN presents the NASCAR Family Cruise to benefit the Winston Cup Racing Wives Auxiliary. Sail into the Caribbean with top NASCAR drivers. There'll be NASCAR festivities and activities, plus stops in the Bahamas and kids fun with Warner Brothers Looney Tunes characters. Call now for 5 days and four nights of nonstop food, fun, and high seas hospitality. It's NASCAR on America's number one family cruise, the Starship Oceanic, leaving Port Canaveral, Florida, December 4th.
To win at this level, you need to have team players. You need to have team spirit. And you definitely need to have team coverage. Team Mopar on TNN Motorsports. It doesn't get any closer.
Due to TNN Motorsports live race coverage, Truckin' USA will be presented at a different time. 5:30 p.m., 4:30 Central, today on TNN Motorsports.
TNN Salute to Motorsports at Opryland from August 24th through September 4th. All types of motorsports will be on display with driver appearances, merchandise, and exhibits throughout the theme park. For more information, call weekdays 615-889-6611 and join us at the TNN Salute to Motorsports at Opryland. What happened to Kevin LePage, Glenn?
Well, Mike, when he came in for that pit stop, of all things, the brakes locked up. It turned the car directly into the wall and did some serious damage. They've had to push the car behind the wall, take it to the garage area. They're taking the war wagons and tool kits back there now to try to get him back in the race. That's a shame, because that's one of the best runs I have ever seen Kevin have, and had the brakes locked up. He made a come into the pits just a little hot, maybe didn't slow the car down enough. You know, you don't use brakes here, and when you stand on them all at once like that, and they're cold, sometimes they'll do that, and that's exactly what happened. He popped the pit wall.
Too bad. I mean, he was at least the top three car today. He was running quite well.
Well, Michael Waltrip made a late pit stop. Larry, how come?
Well, I talked to his crew earlier, and they was pretty disenchanted about their fuel mileage. They could only run 45 laps, which means they had to at least top off by lap 72. They was in here on lap, I think, 69 with the other cars, so just for insurance, they come in here and top the car off, because they felt like it would be very foolish to have a chance and then be out there and run out of fuel at the end of this thing.
So he gets set for a restart.
He's a good company. He got the 20 car there with him and the 23 car, so they'll be able to get back to the front. Chad came in and topped off too, so when you're making a lot of power, you burn a lot of gas.
Well, because of all the wrecks today, you don't have that many cars out there, so you'll start no worse than like 21st or 22nd right now. These guys are back up in a pretty good position now.
19 cars are on the lead lap. As we get set for the restart, Johnny Benson up front, Jeff Green in second, Dale Fishline in his first start of the year, running in third, Terry Labonte in fourth, Larry Pearson would be in fifth, back in sixth, Rick Wilson having a strong run here, seventh, Robbie Reiser. We haven't talked much about the Wisconsin driver. Tommy Houston's car with Jeremy Mayfield aboard, next in line, then Patty Moise, Kenny Schrader, Jeff Fuller, Elton Sawyer, and Johnny Rumley. Kenny Wallace, Joe Nemechek, also on the lead lap, along with Jimmy Spencer, Mike Wallace, Michael Waltrip, and Chad Little. We're back to green.
Well, there's an interesting story right there. You see the fourth-place car right there, that's Larry Pearson. He was in a long spin down the front straightaway here in an earlier accident. He's worked his way all the way back up to fourth spot. He's leading this second group you see there.
Out of turn two. Glenn Jarrett.
Guys, I'm still out of the field. You can see the skid marks where LePage's brakes locked up. Car skidded toward the wall. It bounced into the wall. Bounced into the wall, off the wall, and it spun again. You can see as the camera follows around, boom, right into the Vermont teddy bear stand here. Tore it all up, tore the seams. The stuffing leaked out of it. Tough break for the Vermont teddy bear crew. Also, Larry Pearson, you buddy, you said was running so well. He has a broken right front fender brace on that car. But man, you can never tell it by the way it's running.
Well, that probably won't hurt anything. It'll blow, you know, if it doesn't get into the tire or if it's already fallen off or whatever, it shouldn't hurt anything too bad.
Now, what's happened now is we have three distinct packs of cars. There are your three leaders on the breakaway. And there's the second and third pack of cars. And I think Michael Waltrip and that crowd will take this third pack all the way up, and we'll have one pack in about three laps again.
Won't take very long. It's a pretty fast group right here. You see Mike Waltrip going to the bottom there with Chad Little right on his back bumper. Kenny Wallace in the middle there. He's losing ground.
Kenny Wallace going to have to pick the lead and tack on, and then Red Dog number eight. Spencer side by side with Chad Little. The three leaders, though, are unable to pull away. Back through the tri-oval and heading for turn one. There's that third pack.
Boy, Michael just left Chad hanging. He just dropped.
You're not supposed to tell on your brother.
He dropped right in there and said, bye, Chad.
You know, we used to call that leaving him hung out to dry. I think now we could say he clotheslined him.
Yeah, he did. He did something to him.
See Larry Pearson there. Rick Wilson is running in fifth place right now. He's come from 40th spot.
Now here's Michael underneath Joe Nemechek in number 87. Bell South Mobility Chevy.
Michael's got a fast car. He's just fast down the straightaway. He can really get into it pretty good, and he's got a fast race.
Look at this second group, how they're pulling down. Larry Pearson don't know he's got a busted right front. I can tell you that. He is flying up through there. They've run the leaders down, and now it's one pack, like you said, if it's going to be.
Toward the back of that front pack, Jeremy Mayfield and Tommy Houston's car battle side by side with Fuller. And that second pack is now spread out a bit. Labonte working along in that crowd. And now it's pretty much one long line.
But don't take them long to get them all sorted out there. Now everybody's moving around on the back straightaway. You see the lead cars move to the inside. They don't want to help anybody on the outside trying to move in on them. So they try to break the draft by moving around on the back straightaway.
Kirby Sadler back in the race.
Boy, Mike, he is coming. He's got the hammer down, and he's just coming to the front.
Look at that move slicing to the bottom. Here goes Spencer.
Don't make it four wide, Spencer.
I thought he was going for four wide for a minute. But they both sweep past Pearson and Rick Wilson to move up into the top five.
Well, that's the momentum I was talking about. They do not want to lift. They want to keep that throttle down, and so they got to swerve around a little bit to find a opening so they can keep going. It's an exciting race to watch. It really is. Keep you on the edge of your stool or your seat or whatever you're sitting on.
39 laps to go. And we'll be back with more of the Humminbird Fish Finder 500K from Talladega Live on TNN right after this.
Smaller electrodes, more power. More electrodes, faster start.
Suddenly, everybody has a new spark plug idea promising instant higher performance. But one new plug's idea is higher performance that lasts. Introducing Autolite Double Platinum. Platinum on both sides of the gap for faster starts and more power every time. Platinum to platinum firing for guaranteed peak performance, long after other ideas have peaked out. Autolite Platinum and now Autolite Double Platinum. More precious metal for your precious metal.
Every day, we all find a way. A promise made, a promise kept. Giving it our best.
America's most complete source of auto parts, a national warranty program, and customer service only NAPA can give. No wonder more people trust NAPA to keep their vehicles running.
We keep America running.
Today's exclusive coverage of the Humminbird Fish Finder 500K on TNN is brought to you by NAPA. We keep America running.
Jeff Green on the back straightaway getting into trouble and sliding in through the infield grass and then cracking the wall with the front of the car as they battle for the lead. There is no caution. Let's show you here what happened to Jeff Green.
He's right up in the middle of that front pack.
Yeah, he's coming along there. He drops over. He feels something right here. Oop. I think he got a little help there.
I think he may have got tagged.
Yeah, you see the car turn around. Once it hits this grass, it looks like it picks up speed headed towards the inside.
Kenny Schrader was right behind him. I've noticed three times today Kenny has lifted to let Jeff in line, and it's getting a little late in the race, and Jeff may have just learned a valuable lesson.
A lot of rain here yesterday. And here's Green trying to get back around to the pits. We stay under the green flag. 36 laps to go. Had a race here at Talladega some number of years ago, and Neil Bonnet was leading. It crashed out of the race in a big multi-car wreck, and I said, well, Neil, sorry you can't win it. Who looks strong today? He said the pace car's got a good shot at it.
Wow.
Might have been the only car left.
Here comes Schrader on the outside trying to pass Benson as they go into turn three.
Spencer just got into fish line back there, but he hung on to it somehow.
Three wide just behind this pack of six.
I tell you one thing, they're not intimidating fish line.
No.
I don't know where he's been or what he's been doing, but he's
been in Dave Marcus's shop.
He's holding a pretty wheel right now.
Did you see Mike Walton just in? He got into Spencer just a little bit, but he was quick enough to turn the wheel down and not create a big problem there.
Three wide, nine cars deep.
Gosh.
Unbelievable.
We need to stop these guys and move on to replays of what's happened earlier today.
If they saw it, could they do it?
No.
Look at how tightly they're packed behind Schrader, and everybody wants out of line. Elton Sawyer down to the bottom of the racetrack. They're three wide for second place. Sawyer's going to pull the string all the way to second spot. Here he comes next to Michael Waltrip. He's got the momentum. And he's got the room.
There's Benson on the outside of Michael. There's Schrader. He went to the lead.
All the way to the front, Elton Sawyer. From about 10th place out of turn two, he leads into turn three.
Yeah, well, he just had a tremendous amount of momentum, and he was able to, the hose all opened up for him just right.
That's Jeff Fuller there, three wide, going down toward turn one. He's a rookie here, but he's not driving like one. He's driving like a pro going down into turn one. You see him still three wide there as he goes through the corner.
Michael Waltrip's got shuffled all the way back to eighth place. Let's check with Larry McReynolds.
I'm going to tell you, if there was a peak cool move of the race award, you know, I'd have to tip my hat to Mike Hilleman and these guys in the Jimmy Spencer pit. They come in a while ago. They got the problem fixed. They got the car cooled down. That put them so far back at the end of the field. Then they come in and got their full fresh tires, which certainly works as a handling advantage. But the problem is, just a few laps ago, the temperature is climbing back up. I guess the question is, will it make it another 30-something laps? But whatever the case, these guys have done a great job down here today.
Well, Mike, that could explain why Jimmy's driving as hard as he is today. If you stay out front, you're going to run a whole lot cooler than you are if you're back in that pack. So he needs to keep the nose of that car in clean air and keep as much cool air going into it as he can.
24 lead changes. And now Jeremy Mayfield in relief of Tommy Houston has the Red Devil Ford out front.
That car has quite a bit of damage on it. I'm not sure whether he's in the lead lap or not, but he's driving the wheel.
Check your local listing. NASCAR now reports Randy LaJoy is behind the wheel of Tommy Houston's car rather than Mayfield.
And I assume he's on the lead lap. I'm pretty sure he is. And
he is the leader.
Boy, that's got to make Tommy feel good.
Yeah.
That'll revive you in a hurry.
So LaJoy, who started the year driving Bill Davis's Winston Cup Pontiac and has been in, I think, four different cars in the last week and a half, including this one.
Well, he's driving the wheels off that car, and he has been reported in the lead lap. Indeed, he's leading the race here, and that car has some damage on the right rear corner there.
LaJoy, like his dad, grew up on the Danbury, Connecticut race arena, and he is cut from the same cloth as Jimmy Spencer. If you've ever seen them both in the modifieds back east, they drive the same way, wide open.
They really do, and I've seen both of them. I saw LaJoy right here about 2 years ago keep me on the edge of my seat, and again, a couple of other racetracks in Arlington and some other places. So he knows how to hold the pedal down.
He now has Michael Waltrip and Chad Little bearing down. Fishline and Spencer.
Now, you see, Mike Waltrip, even drafting that slower car on that one flat straightaway there, you hit. Everything moving your way when you're on the straightaway, trying to keep that momentum up.
That was Doug Hebron's damaged car. Now they're going after Randy LaJoy. From the high side, Chad Little and Jimmy Spencer. Just all bunches together. What a job Fishline is doing there in fourth spot.
We may have to change it and call him the Iceman, because he's not a bit. Hanging there like a veteran.
That's that dark blue number 70 car up top.
You can see Chad Little then move down just a little bit. He cut a little bit of the draft off Fishline. Now he's pulling Mike Walter through the corner there.
Yeah, he'll try to run in the middle of the two of them. Don't want to help either one of them anymore than he has to, so he'll try to split the difference.
Dale told me this morning he works all day on day parking his car, then comes home and works half the night on his own.
He keeps driving like this, he won't have to do that much longer.
That's right. That is not a Dave Marcus car. Ivan and Pat Murphy and their six daughters own that race car.
I want you to look at that bad boy take off.
Here he goes for the lead.
And I mean, a lot of guys right there would have lifted a little bit because that car was going to run them out of room. Hey, he didn't lift. He's in the gas.
He didn't lift because Jimmy Spencer dead on his back bumper there. That'd have a lot to do with your decision.
Fishline's got Bob Seneker's ASA crew helping him out here. They came down from the Midwest. Steve Shelton's Satellite Technology Group on the hood, and now he's got Chad Little up and under his quarter panel.
He's doing a good job. That's all I can say. I don't care what happens to him. If he wins the race, he's doing a great job.
See, Johnny Benson looked to the inside there. He fixed it to make it three wide going out through there, but now they're back to the same double file.
And Terry Labonte must have checked his watch and said, well, time to get up there and be part of this, because here comes the MW Windows Chevy, that white number 14.
Well, you don't want your ice to melt too soon.
Nah.
You know? You'd leave it in the old cooler as long as you can.
That's right.
No need getting in a hurry.
29 laps to go. There's Labonte.
He's got a little damage on that third corner there. Oh. I think it's been a contact race, if you want to know the truth.
Bob Labonte, Terry's dad will be all over him for bending that car up like that.
Schrader outside of Elton Sawyer. We'll take one more break here and come back for 28 laps. You're watching Busch Grand National Racing from the fastest speedway on earth, live on the Nashville Network.
With new spark plugs, you get improved performance for a while. But only Bosch Platinum has a pure platinum center electrode that's heat-fused for an airtight seal. So Bosch Platinum reaches its self-cleaning temperature faster for full engine power over a longer performance life. Which means you'll replace a lot of other things before you change your Bosch Platinums. Bosch Platinum, the ultimate spark plug.
Dear Midas, while visiting my family in Gainesville, my brakes made strange noises and stopped working. I went to two dealers and got the same answer.
We can't get brake parts for your car.
We can't get brake parts for your car.
A third dealer suggested,
call Midas.
Your guys removed my wheels, inspected my brakes, and told me,
we can take care of it.
My hat goes off to your employees for such helpful service. Thank you. Bill Cohn.
Once you watch, you're hooked.
Live from Topeka, Kansas, it's the NASCAR Super Truck Series Heartland Tailgate 175. Next Saturday, 6 p.m., 5 Central on TNN Motorsports.
When things are changing, when you're rearranging, the look that's right, that fits your life, is in one store at Rooms and More. Yeah, things are changing at Montgomery Ward.
This week at Rooms and More Montgomery Ward, all furniture is 20 to 50% off, like Serta Queen mattress sets for just $3.99 or Serta Twins for just $99 each piece. Both come with a 10-year warranty and the legendary comfort of Serta. Now that's a dream come true.
All right, class, get out your notebooks. It's convenient. Two campuses, one in Bradenton, one in Venice. It's flexible, AM, PM, year-round. It's for all ages, from the end of high school through the rest of your life. It's affordable, $35 per credit hour. What are we talking about? Manatee Community College. Get your associate in arts or associate in science. Bradenton Campus, 755-1511. South Campus, 493-3504. You will be quizzed on this later.
Welcome back to Talladega. Mike Joy with Buddy Baker, Darrell Waltrip, Jeff Jarrett, and Larry McReynolds on pit road. What a battle.
Mike, there's a story I know you want to talk about right now. We're talking about experience in fourth place right now. Leading candidate for Rookie of the Year, Jeff Fuller, right up there.
Yeah, he and Curtis Markham. Curtis had a tough day, but Fuller, the National Modified Champion, and Dale Fishline, who but for a great run here last year, totally unheralded. Two young drivers and the two blue cars running third and fourth against the Winston Cup veterans, Jimmy Spencer and Michael Waltrip, and Terry Labonte, the Iceman, front five.
It really is. I guess what's really happening right now is Michael is kind of saying, okay, I'm going
to
follow.
There you go, that bump drafting. Everybody wants to know what it looks like.
Yep.
You push them down the straightaway, you ease out the throttle and let them get in the corner good and smooth, and then you push them down the straightaway. Michael's right on his back bumper down the back straightaway.
And Jimmy likes it. See, most drivers would have their hand up in the air saying, oh, please, don't do that anymore.
Oh, Jimmy likes Jimmy it. Jimmy in the modifies. He has his hand up in the air going, come on.
Is that all you got? It's kind of like a fight, you know.
They
hit me with your best shot. Well, here goes our man Fishline. He's all cry on the outside.
Oh, Jeff Fuller almost stuck his nose in there. Kind of got me a little nervous there for him, but... right in fifth place there, Terry Labonte. You can tell it's near the end of the race. He just kind of rolls back all day long. And then when it's time to pay the money, he moves up.
24 laps to go. There's Jim Green back out after having to make a pit stop. We're spinning. Came to the fence under green. Here's your Napa Field standing update. Napa, we keep America running. Here's how they're running. Let's check with Len.
Just a quick update on Mark Martin. I told you that he had a slight limp. Well, it turned out to be a little more than that. He has been removed to Citizens Hospital in Talladega for x-rays. He has a severe bruise inside of his left knee. They've got him there for observation. They don't know anything further than that right now. He's obviously alert and talking and so forth, but the damage to his knee was a little bit worse than what they anticipated at first. As we get more information, we'll let you know, but he is at the hospital right now.
Thanks, Platt. Look at this battle up front. Michael Waltrip up top, comes down to the bottom, and Spencer comes down, takes the nose away from Jeff Fuller, who falls in behind Fishline. Labonte goes up top.
There goes Terry Labonte on the outside, and right behind him, Ken Schrader trying to take the spot away from Fuller.
Yeah. If you ever get up there, those guys need to stay lined up. It's getting late in the race. I mean, I know there's 20-odd laps to go, but they need to stay lined up the best they can now.
Oh, Michael!
Michael, sideways.
Yo, and with the right side. No traffic coming.
What happened?
Didn't see the initial contact, but look how it has pancaked the right side of Michael Waltrip's car.
Oh,
and it noses into the pit wall, probably without brakes.
No brakes. And that probably hurt worse than the other lick did. Wow.
Some of Curtis Markham's crew right there. As they lean over and talk to Michael inside the car, we have gone to caution. Something happened up amongst that front five. And Michael Waltrip, who may have had the fastest car left in this race, is now against the infield wall on pit road.
That inside lick on that pit lane was a hard lick on that left side. That's a couple of really hard licks.
Let's see what happened here.
Whoops. I think he...
Looks like Spencer may have... Well, we'll see that from a little sooner. Yeah, we need to look at that early. Boy, he's in that grass there. You see it don't slow down much at all. Ooh. It hits on the right
side. Boy, that
hurts.
Now, what's really... I mean, he has no brakes. Obviously, when he hit the right front, it broke the brake line off. And now it appears that he's just headed for his pit. But he doesn't have any control over the car, and he doesn't have any brakes.
That was the back glass you can see going out of the car there as he spun.
So now everything, see the right front wheel, how it's turned to the left? He just headed into the pits.
Nothing he can do now.
But he's just a passenger right now. And fortunately, no one's standing along that wall right there. They see that he can't stop.
Looked too, Darrell, like it wouldn't steer at that
point.
Oh,
it can't.
It wouldn't steer or do much of anything like he was trying to steer it.
Okay, here's Jimmy Spencer in the 20 car just under Michael. They come off the corner.
Oh. Yeah, Jimmy got into him. Boy.
As Michael came across Jimmy's lane, the two got together there.
See, the wheels are locked there. He's got brakes now. When it hits, he has no brakes. The wheels are turning now, so...
All right, let's go to Larry McReynolds, who's on the scene there.
Okay, I'm standing here right by the Michael Waltrip car. We won't try to talk to Michael right now. He did take a pretty good shot, but I want to iterate that he is okay. It's so hot, you just can't imagine. Now, I think when these drivers slow down or stop and try to get out like Michael did, that's when it really sinks in just how hot it is. He's taking a little bit of oxygen. They're probably going to take him over to the infield care center and just take him out. They've been giving him a lot of water and wet rags, but again, he's getting out on his own, and we'll go check with him a little bit later.
Okay, thanks, Larry. Good to know that he's okay. Michael Waltrip out of this race after a hard lick. Some close running here. We'll be right back.
If you settle for a remanufactured engine without a brand name, be sure you've got a pair of name brand shoes. AC Delco Engines, the national brand name with the nationwide warranty. Call for a location near you. Of course, if you come in on foot, we'll understand.
Hey, Mike, hand me my channel lock pliers.
Tommy, give me that plier over there with the blue handles. What kind of pliers is that?
These are channel lock tone groove pliers. My dad uses them on his race car, too.
For the tough jobs and the small jobs, reach for channel lock, the handiest plier of them all.
Hey, guys, anybody seen the channel lock pliers?
Channel lock. Be sure you're getting genuine channel lock pliers. Look for this trademark.
Get free, that dog!
I guess they're still mad about the strike, huh?
Telling me?
What do we do?
There's only one thing to do. Take them off of pizza.
What? Are you nuts? You know how much that would cost?
We'll take them to the Pizza Hut lunch buffet. You can get all the pizza, pasta, and salad you can eat for just $3.99.
What's $3.99 times 50,000?
$200,000.
How much you got on you?
About $100,000.
I got two.
I got a quarter mil.
Yeah, you got change?
At Pep Boys, save $40 on our premium brake service. Our ASE certified technicians will install Raybestos lifetime brakes for only $59.99 after rebate. Get lifetime brakes installed for only $59.99 at Pep Boys now. Now at Pep Boys, get any four of our 35,000-mile all-season steel-belted tires at an incredible low $109. That's right, any 75 or 80 series, any four, just $109 at Pep Boys now.
Today's exclusive coverage of the Humminbird Fish Finder 500K on TNN is brought to you by Pep Boys Automotive Super Center.
Aerial coverage today from the 192-foot-long Goodyear blimp Stars and Stripes based in Pompano Beach, Florida. Glad to have Goodyear with us to provide you those aerial views of some of the action and incidents here. Well, they... I'll hook up Michael Waltrip's car and bring it back to the garage. Let's get a further update on Jimmy Spencer's car from Larry McReynolds.
Okay, I'm standing here in Spencer's pits. Guys, there's no doubt why Jimmy Spencer is trying to keep that car out front, because when he's out front leading, the water temperature is 230 degrees. That's something that the engine can live with. But when he's behind cars, That's 260. Just a little past that, it's going to start spitting the water out, and that's when they're going to get in trouble. They're talking about trying to bring him back in, possibly cool it down one more time for this last run.
But if they do, and he loses that lead track position...
No, they're not going to do that. He's going to stay right where he is.
Okay. So we're going to stay right where we are and be back after this break for the final laps here at Talladega.
Isn't it time you stop letting life slip through your fingers? Go for it and grab on. Grab on and live wide. You'll never let go.
Most trackers can follow the trail only as long as the weather holds up. Unless it's a tracker spurred on with genuine AC spark plugs. AC plugs fire faster than lightning for performance so smooth, even the thunder claps. And that'll keep your engine on the trail to a longer life.
Call 1-800-AC-DELCO. It's like buying time.
So better track down some AC spark plugs.
Only
one thing to do. Take
them
off of pizza.
What? Are you nuts? You know how much that would cost?
We'll take them to the Pizza Hut lunch buffet. You can get all the pizza, pasta, and salad you can eat for just $3.99.
What's $3.99 times 50,000? $200,000. How much you got on you?
About 100,000. I got two.
I got a quarter mil.
Yeah, you got change?
Leave it to Peerless Faucet to create a shower so smart, it can not only sense when a toilet has been flushed, it can also adjust the water temperature accordingly. Scald Guard technology by Peerless. Get more out of your faucet than just water.
Athlete's foot is a predator. To cure it all, you've got to kill it all. Today, there's Lotrimin AF spray and powder with full prescription strength medicine that kills all causes of athlete's foot. Lotrimin AF, the killer cure.
Want to see some real racing?
Last year, Tim Biedema and Dennis Setzer made heavy contact, but Setzer stayed alive. Then, with a few laps left, Setzer blew by Ricky Graven and held on to take the win. From South Boston, Virginia, it's short tracking at its finest. The NASCAR Busch Grand National Ford Credit 300, live next Saturday, 5 p.m. 4 Central on TNN Motorsports.
It doesn't get any closer.
Hi, this is Kyle Petty. At the end of the year, myself and four or five other drivers and their families are going to take a trip on the Big Red Boat. We're asking all of you guys to come along and join us. It's for a great cause. It benefits the Winston Cup Racing Wives Auxiliary and a lot of other people. We're going to have a lot of fun, and hopefully we'll all survive. I'll probably get thrown overboard, but maybe I'll make it back.
Well, bring your water skis then, Kyle. Ernie Irvin, Todd Bodine, Ted Musgrave, and Steve Grissom will be participating to benefit the Winston Cup Drivers Auxiliary. The cruise from Cape Canaveral to the Bahamas, December 4 to 7. On the Big Red Boat. For information, call 1-800-972-2359.
Yeah, he went over land on his motorcycle, and now he's going to go over sea on his red boat, right. I guess.
17 cars on the lead lap. Jimmy Spencer leads it. Dale Fishline, Jeff Fuller, Terry Labonte, and Chad Little, the top five. Then it's Kenny Schrader, Johnny Benson, Randy LaJoy, and Tommy Houston's car, Elton Sawyer, and his wife, Patty Moise, ninth and tenth. Rick Wilson, Kenny Wallace, Joe Nemechek, Robbie Reiser, Johnny Rumley, Larry Pearson, and Mike Wallace, who was just on pit road with the hood up. They are all on the lead lap. Still running, Jeff Green, David Green, Kevin LePage has not yet retired that car. Hermie Sadler is back out on the speedway. Curtis Markham still circulating, and Doug Hebron, Tim Fedor, everybody else is in the garage.
Well, Mike, this place is historic for creating a star, a lot of one-time winners here in the Winston Cup division particularly. A couple of guys come to mind, Ron Bouchard and Bobby Hillen, and there are probably some others, Richard Brickhouse. But nevertheless, we may be set up here for that very same thing to happen again today. We've got two guys up there, Jeff Fuller and Fishline, that both have fast race cars and a shot at winning.
Well, Mike, 17 laps to go. It's showtime. dress rehearsal is over. All these guys, as we say that, you see Terry Labonte diving to the bottom side of Fishline there, taking over third.
Fishline's car did not go on the restart, Glenn.
Exactly right, Mike. As they came by me here and everybody was coming up to speed, Dale's car did not take off, wouldn't come up to speed. He pulled up way up next to the wall to try to get out of line. I'll try to get a word as to exactly what happened. I don't know if he missed a shift or what, but it sure didn't take off.
To the back of the pack goes Dale Fishline. Dave Marcus, the crew chief, still on the lead lap. But up front, the two former National Modified Champions may settle this out, Jimmy Spencer and Jeff Fuller.
Well, that'd be interesting. Oh, there's Fishline really high over turns 3 and 4. He's got a tire gun, I believe, or a problem or some sort of thing.
Two cars, then four, to try to run them down. Terry Labonte, Chad Little, Kenny Schrader, Johnny Benson closing on the lead two.
This will be a six car pack in no time flat. Here comes just behind the first two cars there. Terry Labonte has moved in. He's caught him going into turn one now.
Terry Labonte took a long time in this race to make his presence known. He has not led. We've had 28 lead changes. Labonte has not been one of them. Here he goes after Jeff Fuller. Second place.
Now, how did he do that? Terry Labonte's been back here running in the top 15 or 20, and he's going for the lead.
Experience, man.
Got that experience, doesn't he, buddy?
Huh? Yeah.
Labonte and Little running down the leader. There's Fuller on the high side. What happened to Dale Fishline, Larry?
Okay, I talked to his crew chief, and I think Dale missed a shift on that restart and may have hurt the motor. You can relate to that back to Pocono in June when Jeff Gordon missed a shift, hurt his motor, maybe the same thing looks like here's happened to Dale Fishline.
Well, the ice has begun to clink in the glass. Here comes Labonte.
Yeah, well, I tell you, he put his in high gear. He did. He's been running along here in overdrive, I think. He just gets into high gear.
Spencer there in third. He's dropped back right now. Now he's running hot, as we've already found out. He don't want to stay back here. If he can get the drafting partner, he wants to go back in the lead. This car's run hot all day long.
That six car's up there too, and that's a surprise. He was in a wreck earlier. And, so Randy LaJoy is in that car, and you got to give a call to them. They're doing a great job. Really good folks. Tommy Houston's been in this series ever since its inception. He's just done a great job through his career, and it's good to see his car running that way.
Right up in that lead top 10. Of course, there are 17 cars in the lead lap in that pack.
This thing's going to, it'll be at the end just like it was in the beginning. Every car will be on top of each other. And you'll think you're seeing, it's not a tape, it's the finish.
Right. There's no way to script it.
No.
Well, I can't imagine anybody I'd feel more comfortable following here than Terry Labonte. This guy is really a professional in every sense of the word. And right now, if I was running second, I wouldn't be too concerned about him leaving.
No, but you got to be sitting there wondering, where did he come from? Right. I haven't seen him all day long, and here he is leading the race.
I told you, and I told you. He's just going to sit back there, and he'll be there. All right, Jimmy Spencer is looking for a drafting partner. Larry?
I talked to Jimmy's crew chief, Mike Hilleman. He said, yes, they do need a drafting partner. They've been trying to talk to Schrader and his crew, saying if you'll go with us, we'll race you at the end. The question is, will Spencer do that? That's the question.
Yeah, and I was wondering what kind of partner he was looking for, because he's had a couple of close encounters already.
Yes. Well, the other question is, even with a partner, could he get away?
No, you can't get away, but you can get in front.
Glenn. Let's make a deal, Glenn Jarrett.
You know, guys, I'm just wondering how long or how short Ken Schrader's memory is. You know, it wasn't just a couple months back at Charlotte when we saw the altercation between Spencer and Schrader. They weren't too happy with each other then. At least Schrader wasn't too happy with Spencer, but maybe he's forgotten all about that. Maybe he will help him out.
Well, there's a couple of guys over in the garage area that might be partners with Spencer.
All right, folks, 104 laps on the board, 13 laps to go. Five cars at the front shuffle this out, and we'll come back with the finish from Talladega Live after this.
Isn't it time you stop letting life slip through your fingers? Go for it and grab on. Grab on and live wise.
you'll never let go.
Smaller electrodes, more power. More electrodes, faster start.
Suddenly, everybody has a new spark plug idea promising instant higher performance. But one new plug's idea is higher performance that lasts. Introducing Autolite Double Platinum. Platinum on both sides of the gap for faster starts and more power every time. Platinum to platinum firing for guaranteed peak performance, long after other ideas have peaked out. Autolite Platinum and now Autolite Double Platinum. More precious metal for your precious metal.
Into the final laps, 11 to go. Terry Labonte has come out of the middle of the field where he has languished all day to suddenly run to the front and take over the lead. That's Jimmy Spencer way up on the top of the racetrack and slicing down in front of Ken Schrader.
Wow. That was quite a move there, Darren.
That was.
What he's doing, though, he's going high in the corner there to get some fresh air into that car. He is having a heat problem, so when you see him go up like that, there's nothing physically wrong with the car. It's just he's trying to cool it in the corners.
Larry?
I talked to Bob Labonte, Terry's dad and crew chief, and I said, Bob, is this where you want to be right now? And he looked at me with just a solemn face and said, nope. He knows that's not where to be with that many cars behind him right now.
Might want to be one behind the dealer in that stealing seat, so to speak.
Yeah, I think Chad Little's probably got a pretty fast car. We've seen that time and time again. And, of course, that's two Fords against two Chevrolets, so we'll see what happens.
Mike, you know, he's saying, no, I didn't want to be in the lead, but what can happen is what's happening right here. The second, third-place car gets to racing each other. I'd rather be in the lead than anywhere.
All right, let's go to Chad Little's pit. Here's Glenn.
And this is his crew chief, Gary Cogswell. Bob Labonte just said that they didn't want to be where they are right now. What about you guys?
I'm right exactly where I want to be.
Well,
is just a couple laps to go and ride right there in second as long as they can. That's the place to be.
All right, guys, we can't see what's happening.
We have the luxury of replay. He's already taken the lead, Glenn.
Tell Gary he needs to push his button because he should have been telling Chad that.
Yeah, instead of us.
Yeah, shouldn't have been telling you. Should have been telling Chad.
Chad Little has the lead. It's two Fords out front. Little and Spencer. Kenny Schrader in third. Johnny Benson in fourth. And way up high comes Kenny Wallace. Where'd he come from?
Kenny's been running quite well. You see him making a move right there, trying to get by Johnny Benson, who's on the bottom side of him there. Benson needs to get a drafting partner pretty quick, or he's going to drop way back in the field.
Boy, that's a fact. You know, that black flag on Kenny Wallace for jumping the start might have kept him out of some of the melees that have happened here. He has also, like Labonte, worked his way steadily back to the front.
Mike, there's two theories here. One, to be way out front or way out back. You don't want to be in the middle. That's where you get in trouble.
That's what I call the eye of the storm.
Eight laps to go. Every one of these cars is contending for the win.
See Johnny Benson out there hung by himself. He's gone from second place all the way back to about
ninth. Wallace made the move, bobbled it as Fuller went with him, got back in line up high.
Well, that knocked my water over.
Knocked my breath out. Here comes Benson on the bottom. Fuller and Rick Wilson. Fuller!
Oh, no!
And tumbling goes Randy LaJoie over the hood of the 92 Larry Pearson.
There goes the page.
Back to the line. And it is Chad Little leading Jimmy Spencer to the line. A horrendous pileup out of turn four. And we're under caution again. There's Robbie Reiser's car wrecked, Johnny Rumley. David Green limps through there. Chad Little was the first car to the flag.
Boy, man, I'm gonna tell you, it happened so fast here.
And there is Tommy Houston and Jeff Fuller. Both of their cars badly torn up.
Randy LaJoie
in Houston's car. That car went up and over. Now here's Reiser. He's moving around in the car. Looks to be pretty much okay.
Well, this reminds me of a race at Bristol. I mean, you know, we've seen some melees at Bristol like this.
There's Jeff Fuller's car. A lot of damage on the left front corner.
Yeah.
The back end of the car is torn up pretty bad.
Right. Let's see how this guy starts. What happens?
Middle of your screen.
Right here.
Up there into Rick Wilson. Is that Rick Wilson?
Rick Wilson on the outside.
And he's
going
up.
See it start
up,
breaking
up,
loose
yeah.
right there. The back end starts around.
That's classic pulled the air off of my spoiler right there.
Look at Johnny Benson here. How in the world did he get by this?
And Labonte turns around.
Oh, Terry.
Off of Elton Sawyer, and up goes Randy LaJoie.
I didn't even see Terry in that. Boy,
and
look
Reiser.
At that six car. I mean, it's going for a ride.
There's Reiser and Pearson.
The 47 there is Jeff Fuller. You see him coming around right now. Okay, the car is starting to wiggle just a little bit there. It's getting loose. Right now, you see the back end starting around on the car. As he comes around, everybody behind him is just a victim.
Except Benson, who is close enough to get through. And you see Sawyer get into Labonte, turn Labonte. And up and over goes LaJoie. Reiser hits the outside wall. So does Pearson. Reiser spins Fuller around, and Labonte goes straight back into the outside wall.
Boy.
Look at Reiser's car slide after caroming off the infield pit wall. And six cars are demolished.
That was an amazing wreck.
We'll get an update from the scene there for you in just a moment. As they clean this one up with officially six laps to go. We'll be right back.
Dear Midas, my wife's brake light had been flashing on, so we took the car to a repair shop. They failed to properly inspect the brakes and solve the problem. Then we took the car to Midas. Russ did a proper inspection and told me,
"Well, your brake pads are worn, causing your master cylinder to use more brake fluid, in turn causing your light to go on."
Then I got new pads and a guarantee. I should complain to that repair shop, but I wanted to congratulate you instead. Thank you. Dave Buchanan.
If you love your car, what you put on it should be more than just a wax. New Zymol Natural Liquid Auto Polish protects your finish with beeswax and shines with rare Brazilian carnauba. Safe, naturally derived ingredients, so pure, powerful, perfect.
Oh, so beautiful.
New Zymol Natural Liquid Auto Polish.
Once you watch, you're hooked. Live from Topeka, Kansas, is the NASCAR Super Truck Series Heartland Tailgate 175. Next Saturday, 6 p.m., 5 Central on TNN Motorsports.
It's Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
It's the great drive-away getaway.
Giant
auto sale at the Manatee Civic Center. Truckloads of Toyotas, Fords, Chryslers, Plymouths, Jeeps, Eagles, and Suzuki's must go.
You can win one of 20 3-day, 2-night vacation getaways at over 50 U.S. resorts.
Drive-away getaway.
Rock-bottom prices.
On hundreds of new and used vehicles. 3 days only.
This weekend.
At the Manatee Civic Center, Palmetto. It's vacation getaway drive-away.
Madness.
Don't miss it.
Om Shopping Club asks, what's in a name? Om Shopping Club, home to the greatest names in cosmetics.
Right after today's broadcast, stay tuned for NHRA Today. Catch up on all the latest drag racing news from Steve Evans, Dave McClellan, and Bob Fry here on the Nashville Network.
Well, you know, Mike, Chad Little won the Daytona 300 under caution, or with the race ending with a bad crash, and he's in a pretty good shape to do it again today.
Well, the pace car ran over a piece of debris, cut down a tire after all that. There's Terry Labonte's car coming through. Let's have another look here. And there's Jeff Fuller's car. You can see the left rear where Robbie Reiser hit it, secondary to this crash.
See, he's real close on him there, and that's when the back end comes out there. That's just the air getting off the rear spoiler there. Look at Johnny Benson, though. Thread the needle, go right through the center there and avoid any damage whatsoever.
That car stopped on the
inside. That's a 90 car, isn't it? It looked like Mike Wallace was just stopped almost right there.
It was Fishline, we're told. Dale Fishline's car was a car that was just about stopped on the bottom.
Reiser went into the end of this pit wall down here, I think, at pretty high rate of speed.
From Elton Sawyer's car. Wow. packing up Fuller's car. He climbed out of his car okay. He was fine. Robbie Reiser was placed on a stretcher and taken to the infield care center. And there is the sixth car that was being ably driven by Randy LaJoy getting caught up in that. Let's go to Larry.
I'm standing down here at the entrance of pit road where there's a lot of the cars was left laying. And one thing that the guys that's on the lead lap in particular have to really be aware of is all the trash that's laying down here. We've already seen the pace car had a problem. So whether this race stays caution or goes back green, they've got to be careful and make sure they don't run over anything or anything that will cut the tire down. So that'll be something to watch, especially if they go back racing.
Good point, Larry.
Well, I know everybody likes to see it in there in the green. But I tell you, when you get a wreck like this right here at the end of the race, and you get everybody grouped up, and you drop the white drop the white flag one lap to go, I don't like that kind of race.
Here's Larry Pearson's car. Now, he climbed out of his car. Larry was okay. As the only driver we saw taken to the ambulance was Robbie Reiser, who had a tremendous shot into the end of that pit road wall.
Yeah, you can see the tracks there where it went right into the end of the wall.
Chad Little led the race back to the flag, the incident happening behind him. Jimmy Spencer was right on his bumper, but could do nothing with him. We have five laps to go. And let's show you that angle again, and watch for the green car of Robbie Reiser.
He just gets up there, the 47 does, and gets air off his spoiler, and he goes around.
Now here'll come Reiser on the top of your screen, coming in.
Randy
right there into the wall.
Into the wall. And now
into Fuller. And now watch what happens to Reiser's car as it comes to the right side of your screen. This is the one.
That thing is going a high rate of speed and hits right at the end of that pit wall. That was a hard one.
All right, let's check with Randy, or rather Larry, excuse me.
Okay, I'm standing here with Randy LaJoy. Randy, some bad luck early in the day with your own car, but wow, you was giving that Red Devil enamel car really a good ride.
Yeah, it was. You know, our Duraluke car fell out early, had involved in that first wreck, and that car run really well. And I was sitting in the hall watching it, and Scott Houston come up and said his dad wasn't feeling well, so he wanted me to come over and take over the Red Devil, and I jumped in, and we're going like the demons, and I'm not sure what happened, come out of four, but that's better than Carowinds for the ride we took.
You okay, though?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm ready for tomorrow in the Kendall. The car was starting 18th, and we're looking forward to tomorrow.
Okay, let's go back and let's see if we get this thing going green or not.
You know,
that's why he's still racing, I'm not, and yeah. I'm up here talking about it, and he's still enjoying that kind of ride. I'm going to tell you right now, that was hair-raising, but I'm sure glad that Randy was not hurting it. I mean, he turned over pretty hard there.
It's just amazing how drivers can still maintain that sense of humor. Being knocked out of a race, worked hard, in a position to have a great finish, driving somebody else's race car, and he's talking about a ride at Carowinds.
Well,
drivers are drivers weird or what, Baker?
You ought to know, my boy.
Oh, boy. Darrell, when we were at New Hampshire, we talked about that throttle ignition override safety switch.
Oh, yeah.
George Brunhosel and Billy Nassowitz had popularized it. We should have mentioned Tony Pettinelli, the fellow who invented and patented it. He also worked with Richie Evans there out of Rome, New York. He holds the patent. You took one of those back to your team.
We're going to put that on the car particularly for the short tracks. I think it'll be a real safety asset, and we're going to get that on the car for some of the short race drivers.
Need it. Cuts the ignition off if the throttle hangs, and you can read more about that device in the December 87 issue of Stock Car Racing Magazine. They had a great story on it there.
Wow. I'm going to take this little bit of time to say hello to my wife back home. She has Rocky Mountain spotted fever, and she's really had a pretty tough go of it here for the past couple of days. And
hi, Shane.
Be home tomorrow.
Hope you're doing better.
Yeah, I don't want to say hello to my mother and father-in-law. They're in the Baptist Hospital there in Nashville, and they're not doing real well.
Let's go to Glenn Jarrett.
Well, guys, we're standing by with Greg Pollux, and we've all heard about Mark Rippian owning part of Chad Little's car, but this guy is the majority owner and a pretty happy guy right now. At the top of our show, Greg, we talked about how Chad had broken through at Daytona, similar type circumstances, but yet you guys got off to a good start, and looks like good fortune has smiled on you again.
Well, we hope so. I mean, it's never over till the checkered flag falls. You know, we got a long ways to go. I can't believe we're getting set up here for a shootout. We just hope we can keep that bear forward up front.
Got to be proud of these guys, though, the way that they came on strong at the beginning of this year, kept the momentum up. You guys have put together a heck of a team in a short period of time.
Yeah, we did some very specific things. We hired a sports psychologist. He came in. He did a lot of good things for him. John Simpson, I can't give him enough credit. And the guys pulled together. They're young. They got a lot of drive, and they got a lot of determination. You know, we've said all along that will carry more than ability, and this team's got a lot of will.
Well, they certainly do, and I tell you guys, I've been down in their pits for a good part of the day. These guys stay enthused. They know that they've got a chance. Every time Chad makes a move on the racetrack, gets back up front, they're cheering like it's the first time it's ever happened, and believe me, it ain't the first time, and it ain't going to be the last.
No, it's not. Chad Little is poised to take a bite out of Johnny Benson's 76-point lead today. Benson came across the line for that caution in seventh place. Little is the leader. Jimmy Spencer is second, Kenny Schrader is third, Kenny Wallace is fourth, and Rick Wilson currently runs in the fifth spot. Can we get this restarted? We'll find out when we come back.
You're beautiful. Everything I ever want.
If you love your car, what you put on it should be more than just a wax. New Zymol Natural Liquid Auto Polish protects your finish with beeswax and shines with rare Brazilian carnauba. Safe, naturally derived ingredients, so pure, powerful, perfect.
Oh, so beautiful.
New Zymol Natural Liquid Auto Polish.
I remember when the only choice was aspirin. Next came Tylenol, but couldn't always handle all my tough headache pain. And now there's Aleve. But if pain comes back once you've taken it, you could be in pain hours before you can take more. No thanks.
For me, the best choice is Advil. I can take Advil the way I want to.
Advil contains the number one doctor-prescribed pain reliever in its class in non-prescription strength.
Nothing is proven to work better or last longer than Advil. Nothing.
Advanced medicine for pain.
The newest way you can cure athlete's foot is the way doctors cure it. With the same ingredient they've prescribed millions of times. It's new prescription strength Desinex. Nothing cures athlete's foot better. New prescription strength Desinex. The doctor's cure.
One of these hammers is jacketed in high-impact polycarbonate. The other one is broken. The fiberglass jacketed hammer from Stanley.
Every day, we all find a way.
America's most complete source of auto parts, a national warranty program, and customer service only NAPA can give. No wonder more people trust NAPA to keep their vehicles running.
We keep America running. We keep America running.
It'll be a one-lap shootout, and then following our telecast, NHRA Today with all the latest drag racing news right here on TNN. The Busch Grand National Circuit rolls on 1 week from today, July 29th. The Ford Credit 300 will bring it to you live from South Boston, Virginia, exclusively here on the Nashville Network. Great short track action there. Elton Sawyer got his first win last year. Or was that Myrtle Beach? Was that South Boston or Myrtle Beach?
Myrtle Beach.
Okay, we'll go South Boston. We've been to Myrtle Beach. We're going to go racing for one lap.
Boy, this is a gambler situation here. If Chad gets a great restart, let's say he gets a 10-15 car lead going into turn one, and he's got that going down the back, Spencer drafts up to him, passes him going into turn three, and drags half the field with him. So this is a tough situation right here.
Very.
Only thing Chad can hope is get a great restart, get everybody racing behind him, he wins the race.
Here are the cars on the lead lap. Chad Little, Jimmy Spencer, Kenny Schrader, Kenny Wallace, Rick Wilson, the top five, then Joe Nemechek, Johnny Benson, Elton Sawyer, Mike Wallace, Patty Moise, and Johnny Rumley. We're told there is severe weather in Nashville, and it may affect the quality of your picture due to our transmission. So we'll do what we can with that, but it is a weather-related problem if you're having any picture breakup. Right here at Talladega, we're set to go for one lap.
Darrell talking about all the things that Chad Little did.
Pace car's got a good shot at it.
I think Chad Little, if he gets a good start and straight, moves around enough,
he takes
Chad,
I think Kenny Beaver.
Well, then I got
Roundup.
Welcome, Phil Parsons, driver of the number 99 Luxair Chevrolet. Phil, ready for the big race?
Don't think I'm going.
What?
You know how hot it gets in that car.
Oh, sure, Phil, but you're,
comfortable right here at home with high-performance Luxair Central Air.
But what about your fans?
Fans? You don't need fans in a house with Luxair Central Air.
Thank you, Phil Parsons.
Folks, look in the yellow pages for your Luxair dealer or call 1-800-LUXAIR.
Hey, I like to save money as much as the next guy. But what are the odds that there's going to be a sale on the part you need when your car breaks down? Hey, it's not going to happen. That's why I go to AutoZone. I mean, sure, you could wait around for a couple weeks and maybe beat their price by a few pennies someplace else. But I don't want to wait for a sale when I need a part. Now, what more could you ask for?
And it's like a coverage of the Humminbird Fishfinder 500K on TNN has been brought to you by Avalon Formula 3 Motor Oil. Add more life to your car. Take it to the star. And by Smooth Busch Beer and Easy Drinking Busch Light. Busch, the official beer of NASCAR.
Once again, we'll mention the problems with the cable transmission reaching your home are due to severe weather in Nashville and beyond the control of the network, so we'll continue along here best we can and go to the garage area and Glenn with the Busch Series point leader.
And he still is that points leader, and I tell you what, he didn't win the race today, but he's the smartest guy here. First thing he did when he got out of his race car, came over here to the Union Station where there's a little mist shower there. Got a little cool, refreshing shower there. Johnny Goodrun.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, I was just trying to take a fire retardant shirt off, and man, my cool helmet quit 20 laps in, so it was pretty warm today. But Lipton T, Monte Carlo ran great, and Steve Bird and all the guys, man, what a super job.
After the last couple of weeks, the things have been happening to you. Good to have a good solid run under your belt.
Yeah, it sure is, you know. And, you know, it's the first time I've actually got some good speedway drafting. You know, we ended up at Daytona 10th, but didn't get a lot of drafting, and we didn't get to run this. Well, we started to run it last year and broke on a first lap. So I'll tell you what a great job this team's doing. And you know, looking forward to see if we can't stay in a point lead the rest of the year.
Well, he's certainly going to be tough for the rest of the year. This young man's stock keeps rising every week. He's shown the guys that are looking now he can run on a super speedway too. Johnny Benson, one of the stars of the future in Winston Cup racing.
One of the stars of today of this series. He has a 51-point lead. Jeff Green, 318 points out. Chad Little, of course, in second. Little wins it. Spencer second. Wallace third. Kenny, that is. Nemechek fourth. Benson was fifth. Mike Wallace sixth. Patty Moise seventh. Rick Wilson, Ken Schrader, Elton Sawyer, that's the top 10. Johnny Rumley had a lead lap finish. He was 11th today. Back in 12th would be Jeff Green. 13th would be Dale Fishline. 14th was Jeff Fuller after that final incident. 15th, Terry Labonte. Back in 16th position, and this is unofficial, all of this, Randy LaJoy in relief of Tommy Houston. 17th, Larry Pearson. 18th, Robbie Reiser. 19th, David Green. And 20th, Michael Waltrip. Hermie Sadler, 21st. 22nd was Kevin LePage. 23rd, Tracy Leslie. In 24th was Bobby Dodder. 25th, Curtis Markham. 26th, Doug Hevron. 27th, David Bonnet. 28th was Tim Fedewa. 29th, Steve Grissom. And 30th, Mark Martin. 31st, the pole sitter, Jeff Purvis. Right behind him, the outside pole sitter, Mike McLaughlin. 33rd was Jason Keller. 34th, in his debut in that car, Randy LaJoy in the Shoemaker car. 35th was Phil Parsons, who qualified well. 36th, Ward Burton, who took that wild ride on his roof. 37th, and all in that same incident, Bobby Hamilton. 38th, Jim Bowne. 39th, Rodney Combs. 40th, Hut Strickland. 41st, Stevie Reeves. And 42nd, the final finisher, Randy Porter. Let's show you once again that final lap. The last part of it, as Chad Little will beat Jimmy Spencer back around to the line. This is turn three, buddy. Has Spencer got any options at this point?
Well, you see Spencer checking the outside, but Chad Little's got a very fast car, the third car there. Kenny Wallace is making a bid, but a little too late. He does not have the momentum. You see Spencer trying the bottom, but cannot make the move on Chad Little towards the line.
So Little holds him off to win both Daytona and Talladega, the two longest races on the Busch circuit. We'll be speaking to you next Saturday from South Boston, Virginia, from the biggest track on the circuit to one of its smallest. Boy, that's going to be fun.
We always have a great time at South Boston, and you think this was something today? More of the same next weekend.
Everybody okay in that final incident? Even Robbie Reiser was taken to the care center. He's all right. Take just a second to say happy birthday, Mom, last Monday. And my dad turns 80 today. They're having a big barbecue for him up in Massachusetts. So for Buddy Baker, Glenn Jarrett, Larry McReynolds, and Darryl Waltrip, this is Mike Joy congratulating Chad Little. We'll speak to you next Saturday from South Boston, Virginia, here live on the network that brings you more Busch Grand National Racing Live than all other television outlets combined, the Nashville Network. Sail to the